edge the Giants 3-2. So if you're following along here, for those counting, that is 9 games in Major League Baseball in one day decided by one run. That is the most one-run games in one night this season. Just a thrilling day. Those one-run games, 3 walk-offs, and a Yankees-Red Sox game as well. Plenty to be excited about in Major League Baseball. Plenty to be excited about with today's top sounds. Here's Steve Lennox.
Number 4.
Chris, a night of walk-offs around Major League Baseball. Let's start in Chicago. Luis Robert delivering in the home ninth inning for the White Sox. The call, ESPN 1000.
Swing and a ground ball, fair ball, left field corner. Here comes Elvis as he touches home plate. The White Sox walk off the Marlins.
Number 3.
Game 4 NBA Finals Friday night in Miami. Aaron Gordon helping the Nuggets to another road victory and a 3-1 lead in the series over the Heat. Kesty, Mark Kestisher, PJ Carlissimo, Doris Burke had the call here on ESPN Radio.
Jamal Murray looks at Michael Malone. Left-hand dribble. Crosses to the right. Back to the left against Duncan Robinson. Drives in. Sends it to Gordon. Corner 3. It's good for Aaron Gordon. 25 for Gordon in game 4.
Third 3. Just playing off his teammates. He's been brilliant.
Number 2.
And Chris, back to the baseball walk-offs in Philadelphia. Dodgers and Phillies tied in the bottom half of the ninth inning. Kyle Schwarber played the role of hero. The call of this walk-off bomb, courtesy of Sports Radio 94 WIP.
The 1-1. Swung on.
Hit deep. Right field. He's won it. Walk him off, Kyle Schwarber.
Number 1.
Astros and Guardians in Cleveland. Bottom of the 14th inning. That's when Will Brennan said, you know what? It's time to go home. Tom Hamilton the call on WTAM 1100.
A swing and a liner to deep left. Back goes McCormick. It's over his head. Around third, coming home. Freeman scores the winner. Brennan delivers the third walk-off win.
Steve Lennox continuing the theme of Major League Baseball. Big day for the Diamondbacks. Surprise team in the NL West pounds the Tigers.
2-2. There's the swing. That ball's drilled down the left field line. It's deep to the corner. That ball is gone! First career grand slam for Corbin Carroll. A laser down the left field line. And the Diamondbacks have blown it open. It is 9-2.
Arizona Sports 98.7 FM. How about 7 runs in the 7th inning for the Diamondbacks? They beat the Tigers 11-6. Struggles continue for the New York Mets. They are doubled up by Pittsburgh.
There's a line drive left field and a base hit. Extra bases for Hayes. It's a 2-run double. The Bucks have put 10 on the board. Hayes is 3-for-3 and has driven in 4.
93-7 the fan. 14-7 Pirates over the Mets. 7 straight loss for the Mets, longest streak since 2019. And New York has allowed 13 runs in consecutive games for the 3rd time in franchise history. Cardinals-Reds, close game, but the Cardinals, the team that squeaks by.
Nolan Gorman is 0 for his last 10, and he has struck out all 3 times tonight, but still is dangerous, and he hits that ball high and deep to right, and that is gone. The 3rd 2-run home run of the game for the Cardinals. Gorman hits his 15th, and he is indeed dangerous.
Dangerous indeed on the Cardinals radio network. Cards 7, Reds 4. Padres upend the Rockies 9-6.
Here's the 2-1. Kim waits on it, lines it into center field. Grichuk charging in, won't get there. Has to play it on a hop. Bogarts will come in and score from third base. An RBI single for Ha-Seong Kim. Padres have opened the 5th inning with 3 consecutive hits, and they now lead it 7-1.
9-6 the final, 97-3 the fan. Padres 15 hits in the game, 4th highest hit total in a game this season. And the elsewhere in baseball, Athletics beat the Brewers by the score of 5-2. Coming up next, how Denver put itself on the doorstep of a title on SportsCenter all night.
Coming up Monday, James Harden, Kyrie Irving, CP3. I'll tell you where they all go and what their best landing spots are. Monday morning at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio, ESPN2, and ESPNU.
The top headlines are next on SportsCenter All Night.
Coming up Monday, a lot of NFL players got paid big bucks this offseason. I'll tell you which ones are poised for a disappointing season. Monday morning at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio, ESPN2, and ESPNU.
This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio.
Have you seen the cost of eggs lately? With these prices, we'd barely be scraping by if it weren't for Dave. It's the banking app that advances us up to $500 instantly. There's no interest, late fees, or credit checks. No joke. You can get extra cash for anything your family needs. Download the Dave app now or go to Dave.com. For terms and conditions, go to Dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Banking services provided by Evolve, member FDIC.
Netflix, Amazon Prime, HBO, Showtime. Do you feel like your streaming subscriptions are out of control? Why not start the new year off right and cancel the ones you're not using? Enter the Rocket Money app. Rocket Money organizes your subscriptions by due date and notifies you when something is coming up. From there, decide whether to keep it or cancel it with just a tap. To find out more about Rocket Money, go to rocketmoney.com/gameday or download the Rocket Money app from the Apple App or Google Play stores. Rocket Money, the finance app that works for you.
I'm Zoe. I own Muck and Brass, which is an upcycling homewares business. And this is why I switched to Shopify. One of my biggest challenges was the lack of support when I really needed it. And it would always slow down the momentum of my business. With Shopify, I could get hold of a real person quickly. And not only would they solve a problem I had, they'd also give me the tools to feel empowered moving forward. I felt like I didn't even know who my customers were. Thanks to Shopify analytic tools, I feel more confident with the products I'm creating and the sales are actually reflecting that. With Shopify's theme editor, I can easily share elements of who I am in my shop and have full control of how my brand is represented. I spent nearly 7 years on other platforms and I'm kicking myself for not making the switch earlier. Not only do I know my customers better, but they know me better as well. Start your new journey today on Shopify.
Get a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/play. That's shopify.com/play. Go to shopify.com/play to take your business to the next level today.
Will they find a home? Sponsored by Geico. Sarah wants a yard.
My own little paradise.
Brad, however, hates yard work.
The only thing I hate more than cutting the grass is paying someone to cut the grass.
Compromise is tough, but these two won't have to compromise when they bundle home and car insurance with Geico. It's easy, and they could save even more. In the end, Sarah and Brad found a great home with a yard. A very, very small yard.
Time to get it done. And I'm done.
Bundling without compromise at geico.com.
Finally, baseball is back. Swing into the season with tickets to the action. Plus, with basketball and hockey heating up, now is a great time to experience a game. Vivid Seats is proud to be the official ticketing partner of ESPN. From on the glass to in the stands, Vivid Seats has great ticket prices to all the games. Every crack of the bat, every dribble down the court. Catch it all with Vivid Seats. Download the app or visit vividseats.com today. Vivid Seats. Experience it live. Did you know YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable? That's right. YouTube TV has no long-term contracts or hidden fees, and it even lets you catch up to the live game with key plays. With a lineup of over 100 channels, you can watch live TV like cable. Signing up is simple. Get started in minutes, and you can watch all the action of the NBA Finals live on ABC. So what are you waiting for? Try it free today at youtube.com/NBA23. New users only. Terms apply. Cancel anytime.
You've never had anything like Kentucky Fried Chicken's new chicken nuggets. They're so good, you'll hear a random choir singing every time you open the box. Don't believe me? Just listen. Box open.
KFC Chicken Nuggets. KFC.
Box close. Open. Close. Can we get a remix? Order KFC's new chicken nuggets on the KFC app today. That's finger looking good. Prices and participation may vary.
Thank you.
today on ESPN Radio.
Here's the first one to Freeman, driven well right center field. That one blasted, turning, looking out of here.
Freddie Freeman and the Los Angeles Dodgers storm into Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia to go head-to-head with Kyle Schwarber and the Phillies.
Schwarber demolishes one.
The Dodgers and Phillies. Coverage begins today at 3:30 Eastern on ESPN Radio. You can also listen on the ESPN app and on your smart speaker. On SportsCenter All Night. The Nuggets look to take a 3-1 lead in the NBA Finals.
Jokic will hand it off to Murray. Murray to the right with six to shoot. Left-hand dribble. Hops back beyond the arc. Shoots the three and buries it straight down.
He needed to step back because Bam Adebayo was the defender and he used the step. That's a tough shot.
We go around the diamond in another great day of baseball.
There's a line drive left field and a base hit. Extra bases for Hayes. It's a two-run double. The Bucks have put 10 on the board.
We get you ready for Game 4 of the Stanley Cup Final.
You can never count the series done until the home team loses.
And the Super Regionals have started in college baseball.
Speed and Storm delivers it out in the left field. They're waving into Giacomo from third. Here comes the throw.
This is SportsCenter All Night.
You left me on the pickleball court by myself last night, so.
No comment, man.
Here's Chris Lewis.
SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio and ESPN app. It is presented by Progressive Insurance.
Desperation for Miami. Opportunity for Denver. Game 4, NBA Finals. After the Nuggets won on the road Wednesday night, taking a 2-1 series lead. Denver dominated the paint in Game 3, outscoring the Heat 60-34, and that's part of the reason why ESPN reporter Tim Bontemps had the road team as the heavy favorite.
All the role players need to hit threes. I mean, it's really that simple. If Miami hits their threes and holds down Jamal Murray, they have a chance to win the game. If they don't, they won't. And that's really the story of this series, and it's why I think Denver's going to win the next two games and win the title, because I just think that, you know, Gabe Vincent said it best after Game 3 when he said we have a small margin for error, right? And the Heat really do have a small margin for error in this series in particular.
Well, not only did the Heat struggle inside the arc in Game 3, as Tim Bontemps was hinting at, their three-point variance took a downturn too. After hitting 53% of their open threes in their Game 2 win, Heat combined to shoot just 15 for 40. That's 38% on open threes. And their two losses in the series. Now, Jimmy Butler, he was on a mission to change that in Game 4.
Lowry with 2.3 seconds to go. Inbound Butler, contested corner three is good at the horn of the first quarter. And the Heat lead after 12 minutes in Game 4.
We may have playoff Jimmy in attendance tonight.
Mark Kestisher and PJ Carlissimo along with Doris Burke on ESPN Radio. Heat led 21-20 after one. Now, speaking of unlikely threes, Aaron Gordon, not the Nuggets player you would expect to ignite from deep, but he was left open from behind the arc and buried a couple of second quarter triples. But similar to Game 1, he also took advantage of size mismatches inside.
Finds Porter drifting into the deep corner, sends it back to Gordon, who directs traffic from the left. Against the smaller Vincent, takes him off the bounce, drags the feet in the lane, puts it up, puts it in, and one.
Didn't look pretty, but it was. He took the hit, and then he made the shot.
Gordon averaged 13 points per game in the playoffs. He eclipsed that in the first half of Game 4. Denver led it by 4 at the break. Now, the first punch of the second half, that also came from the Nuggets. Jokic, a big part of that Denver run. Now, despite an early ankle tweak, the big man continued his steady dominance. By the end of the third, he had tallied a double-double with a chunk of his scoring from deep.
Here's Murray, sends it on top to Jokic, a wide open three. He's going to make another. Jokic, three triples, 23 points.
They're dragging that screen out. Jamal is just stringing it out and making that an easy play for Jokic.
Jokic finishes with 23 points and 12 rebounds. But in Denver, they'll be calling Game 4 the Aaron Gordon game for decades to come. Every time the Heat tried to rally in the third, the Arizona product would make another play.
Jamal Murray looks at Michael Malone, left-hand dribble, crosses to the right, back to the left against Duncan Robinson, drives him, sends it to Gordon, corner three. It's good for Aaron Gordon. 25 for Gordon in game four.
Third three, just playing off his teammates. He's been brilliant.
A 13-point lead for Denver entering the fourth quarter. It's a spot where the Heat have been in before. Already 7 wins this postseason when trailing by 10 or more points. And to add to the drama, Jokic picked up his 5th foul with over 9 minutes left in the frame. The Heat, they cut it to a 5-point contest. Didn't matter this time. Bruce Brown and company helped close it out for Denver.
Hands it off to Bruce Brown, who's got the last 6 points for the Nuggets. He's got 16. They haven't lost this year when he scores over 12. Drives, reverse layup, good! Bruce Brown back in Miami where he started in college, and he's given the Denver Nuggets an 11-point lead. Here's Adebayo driving, knocked away, Jokic. Aaron Gordon on the other end, sends it to the right side, KCP for 3. Down it goes with 149. The Nuggets hop off their bench. Denver leads by 14, their biggest lead of game 4.
That crunch time run, a 22-10 run, helped seal the deal for Denver down the stretch, giving the Nuggets a commanding 3-1 series lead. They get the win on the road in Miami, 108-95, to go up 3-1 in the series. Jamal Murray had 15 points, 12 assists, did not turn the ball over. Third most assists in a game in the finals without a turnover in league history. Jokic mentioned his 23-12, 17th double-double of the postseason. Nuggets take that 3-1 lead. 35 of the previous 36 teams went on to win the NBA title that have had the 3-1 lead. Now, it's a career playoff high, 27 points for Aaron Gordon, a performance that Nuggets fans will always remember. And after the game, he spoke to ESPN Radio's Ross Gold on Wooday.
Aaron, you guys played with the lead, and you know they're good at comebacks. What did you focus on defensively to get critical stops?
Well, limiting them to one shot. So we got to, probably I'm still out of breath a little bit.
I know, you did a lot out there.
So rebounding, and then contesting all of their threes. They were shooting at a high clip when it was uncontested. We knew if we could contest a little bit more, try and just get their field goal percentage down a little bit, 3-point percentage down a little bit, I think we'd be in good shape.
You know, in the fourth quarter, Jokic came into the huddle and I saw him passionately speaking to the team. He picks his spots. When he speaks up like that, what does that mean to your team, especially in a game like this?
It's big, man. You know, he's a leader and he leads by action, you know? So for him to speak up and lead with his voice too, we know that he's engaged. We know that he wants it, and everything he says is correct. You know, he's a maestro when it comes to this game.
You had a great game yourself, a playoff career high 27 points. You've waited your whole career to be on a contending team, to be in the NBA Finals. You found a fit in Denver. What does it mean to you to step up this way on this stage?
Feels good. Job's not done yet, though. It's just a lot of work, you know, a lot of work. I'm so blessed to be in this organization and around all these great players and this great coaching staff that have helped me to achieve this level. It's really the team. It's really the organization. You know, we all lift each other up. We make each other better.
Lastly, you got a chance to close this out at home. What kind of effort will it take to finish it?
It's going to take everything. It's going to take everything because we know this team's not going away. This team has no quit in them. They're all fight. So we're going to just need another really, really great performance to close out at home.
All right. Thanks. Congrats.
Thanks, Ross.
No problem, AG.
Well, Gordon made impactful plays from the opening tip. The vet entered the NBA as a teenager from Arizona, spent his first 7 seasons with the Magic, who weren't contenders. He was traded to the Nuggets in the 2021 season. According to ESPN analyst Tim Legler on SportsCenter, he has been the ideal match.
There's a reason they targeted him specifically to join this group. He was the perfect addition when they picked up Aaron Gordon for that exact reason. Mm-hmm. He's a guy that put up big numbers on some nights in Orlando, right? At nights, he had to be the guy in Orlando as the focal point of their offense. But now you look at what he's had to do since he got to Denver. he absolutely is going to take what's available to him on a given night and be satisfied to do that. Because when guys play like this, what they're telling you first and foremost, because they say it all the time, it's all about winning. This is actually backing it up. When you play the way that he does and accept that from night to night, your shot chart and your field goal attempt line on that box score, it could look dramatically different depending on how things break for you in that game. But Scott, I think if any game epitomized who this group is as a team, it was this game. Your stars don't play great offensively, but still very impactful. You always need that third guy to have a big night, whoever that may be. Tonight it was him.
Well, the key stretch and what might be the defining game of this year's finals came in the fourth quarter. The Nuggets were in control, but Jokic picked up his fifth foul with 9:24 left. Denver was up by 10 at the time, but Miami cut it down to 5. The run of the season for the Nuggets to extend that lead back up to double digits came with Jokic on the bench. After the game, Coach Michael Malone discussed that stretch.
We're up 13 to go in the fourth quarter. They start out 8-0. And that coincides with Nikola picking up his fifth foul. So they came out aggressively. They have us on our heels. And usually in the regular season, when Nikola went out, things kind of went haywire. But I can say not just tonight, Mike, but throughout these playoffs, however many games we've played now, the non-Nikola minutes have gone really well. And we called a timeout. We ran a play, ATO, Jamal knocks it down, really well executed. And then that unit that was out there, you know, Jamal, Bruce, Jeff, Aaron, and then, you know, KCP or Christian, they defended.
Well, that poise has the Nuggets up 3-1 over the Heat in the NBA Finals. The only team to overcome a 3-1 deficit in the Finals, the LeBron-Kyrie Cavs in the 2016 Finals. Game 5 from Denver, Monday night. ESPN Radio's coverage begins 7:30 p.m. Eastern. Tip-off 8:30 p.m. Eastern on ABC, ESPN Radio, and the ESPN app. Sports Center all night. Chris Lewis here on ESPN Radio. It's hard to believe we're over a week into June and the Red Sox and Yankees haven't faced each other yet. That changed Friday night. Two rivals squared off for the first time this season. New York had taken the last 5 meetings from Boston last year. Of course, the Yankees playing without Aaron Judge, who was placed on the IL Wednesday. New York missed his offense while Boston brought the power.
Here's Devers. Cole throws, and Raffy rockets one high and deep into left field. Kiner Falefa at the track, at the wall, gone! Devers gets Cole again. His 7th home run against Cole, and the Red Sox lead it 2-0.
And the Red Sox go on to win it 3-2 on WEEI 93.7 FM. That actually snaps a 6-game losing streak for the Red Sox against the Yankees. Devers, 2-for-4 with that home run, his 14th home run of the season. Another matchup that brings that big-time feel to it. While the Yankees and Red Sox have the history, the one with the division leaders is in Tampa. In fact, the Rangers and Rays entered the weekend with the 2 best records in the American League. Game 1 of the series, the Rays remain stingy at home.
Swing and a drive, deep to left, to the corner. Gone! Isak Paredes 4, and the Rangers 1. As he hits his 10th home run of the year, a 3-run shot in the third.
620 WDAE. The Rays beat the Rangers 8-3. They've won 7 in a row, first team with multiple 7-game winning streaks this season. In the NFL, the Vikings made it official Friday. The team released Dalvin Cook, ending the running back's 6-year tenure in Minnesota. Cook, he produced 4 consecutive 1,000-yard seasons from 2019 to 2022, combined 29 rushing touchdowns during the 19 and 20 seasons. ESPN reporter Dan Graziano joined Fitz and Harry to explain it from the Vikings' perspective.
Last year, new coach and new GM, right? And they win 13 games. Kind of, my guess is if you got them in an honest moment, they would say that was a surprise. They obviously needed a lot of work on defense. And I don't know that, I mean, they're looking at Kirk Cousins as the long-term answer there. So my guess is, you know, my sense of it is rather that these guys are trying to, you know, build something long term for the future. And so they've spent this offseason unloading guys that make a bunch of money, and they didn't think we're going to be a part of it going forward.
Vikings saved $9 million in cap space, taking on $5.1 million in dead money on their 2023 cap. Coming up next, why the Stanley Cup Final is far from over. This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio.
Coming up Monday, a lot of NFL players got paid big bucks this offseason. I'll tell you which ones are poised for a disappointing season. Monday morning at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio, ESPN2, and ESPN News.
This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio.
MLB fans, when you need tickets to catch your favorite team live all season long, Ticketmaster's got them. As the world's largest ticket marketplace, Ticketmaster has a wide selection of seats available and at competitive prices, so you never have to worry about missing a game. Take yourself out to the ballpark this season and get tickets today at Ticketmaster.com/MLB. That's Ticketmaster.com/MLB.
Exclusively on ESPN Plus, UFC 289 tonight. Welcome to my house. Amanda Nunes,
the greatest of all time,
defends her bantamweight title against Arayne Aldana. And Charles Oliveira takes on Beneil Dariush in a pivotal lightweight fight. UFC 289 tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern. Buy it on ESPNplus.com/PPV.
Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max.
Mo Black in New Jersey. You're on KJ.
Mo Black.
What? Mo Black. It's just an M-O Black.
You
Mo
sure
Black.
Say Mo Black? Because I don't know.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Sure hasn't heard that one before.
What up, Mo? Hey, what's up, guys? Hey, right, man, shout out to you guys, man. Honestly, I think your show is like one of the most underrated shows on TV. And Max, you the man. Jay, I'm from New Jersey. I went to St. Benedict's Prep.
Oh,
and you
okay.
are considered basketball's finest.
Newark,
and,
stand
and,
up.
And New Jersey royalty. And Key, I got to say, man, next to Jalen Rose, you got the second best hairline on TV, all right? I just want to put that out there. And shout out to the DJ. Okay? Now, what I want to get to.
Wait, who has the best hairline on TV, Mo?
Jalen Rose. It's got to be Jalen Rose.
Okay. Key, I'll let you take it away.
Key, you're
number two.
You're right there.
GJ and Max, followed by Greeny. Mornings on ESPN Radio and on the ESPN app. The biggest names in sports are on ESPN Radio.
Shane Battier, two-time NBA champion.
The all-time great discussion. I don't think you get into that conversation unless you win a championship.
Glenn Big Baby Davis won a championship with the Celtics.
When we need to succeed, Paul's going to be there. I just don't see that in Tatum yet. I think he needs to understand the times to turn it up and the times to sit back.
Jalen Johnson, Bears cornerback.
Really, there's nothing that he can't do. I think once he gets comfortable, think he can be very dangerous, and you'll see a lot of that dominant quarterback play that you saw at Ohio State.
Alex English. Is that an insult to be told on the all-time underrated squad, Alex?
I feel the same. To not be named to the top 75 was a very big disappointment. To be the top scorer in a decade, bewildering to me. Why would that not be part of the criteria?
The biggest names in sports come here, and it all starts weekday mornings with Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max, and continues all day. This is ESPN Radio, the Hoop Collective Podcast.
This is the hope in the NBA, right? That you don't have to be Los Angeles or Golden State where Kevin Durant wants to come or LeBron James wants to come, that you can do it that way. I've compared Milwaukee and Denver potentially now winning as a reason why you have hope.
Absolutely. It's a reminder, not, you know, Denver, but then also, like, you look at Miami, like, it's slapping us all in the face. Like, this is a team sport.
The Hoop Collective Podcast. Listen on the ESPN app or wherever you listen to podcasts.
How rare is it, Tim, to have the type of personality where your appetite for shots is such that if I don't get them, I'm good with that? I would think that's difficult to do.
Extremely. And there's a reason they targeted him specifically to join this group. He was the perfect addition when they picked up Aaron Gordon for that exact reason. Mm-hmm. He's a guy that put up big numbers on some nights in Orlando. Right? At nights, he had to be the guy in Orlando as the focal point of their offense. But now you look at what he's had to do since he got to Denver, he absolutely is going to take what's available to him on a given night and be satisfied to do that. Because when guys play like this, what they're telling you first and foremost, because they say it all the time, it's all about winning. This is actually backing it up. When you play the way that he does and accept that from night to night, your shot chart and your field goal attempt line on that box score, it could look dramatically different depending on how things break for you in that game. But Scott, I think if any game epitomized who this group is as a team, it was this game. Your stars don't play great offensively, but still very impactful. You always need that third guy to have a big night, whoever that may be. Tonight it was him. But then look at, you know, what you get from Bruce Brown tonight. Look at, Jamal Murray talked about that three Jeff Green hit. He took one shot.
Yep.
It was enormous, a corner three. KCP,
6-9,
KCP, biggest defensive play of the game, a double strip on Jimmy Butler in the lane in a six-point game that leads to a transition layup going the other way. So, and then, you know, we talked about what Christian Brown did in the last game.
Yep.
This is a team, and Jamal Murray was referencing that a lot in his post-game sound.
This is Sports Center All Night. Here's Chris Lewis.
Sports Center All Night on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app, presented by Progressive Insurance. Another Florida Panthers playoff game, another overtime winner Thursday. The latest helped pull Florida within a 2-1 deficit in the Stanley Cup final against Vegas. Florida 7-0 this postseason in OT. Overall, they've won 10 straight overtime playoff games. Second longest streak of OT playoff wins all time, behind only the Canadiens at 14 straight from 93 to 98. And that's evidence to Tony Kornheiser on PTI to not count the Panthers out.
They're in it right now. You can never count the series done until the home team loses. And Florida won at home. And they got contributions from their most important guys, the goalie, who had been pulled in game two. You know, he comes back out there and he gets 25 saves, and everybody says it's a very, very solid performance. And their best offensive player, Tkachuk, who'd spent the first game being tossed and the second game 10 minutes in the penalty box, and he gets the tying goal with a little over 2 minutes to go.
And the third game, he almost got knocked out. He almost got knocked out early last night.
So he's on the ice in the overtime goal. So, you know, Florida's still alive, kids.
With the Panthers win, it is the second straight year the home team wins game three in the cup final when down 2-0. Lightning won game three against the Avalanche. Meanwhile, Michael Wilbon notes it was a missed opportunity for the Golden Knights.
I thought the Golden Knights gave one away. And their reaction was, I was very curious about it. I stayed with it and watched all the post-game chatter. And it was interesting. Their approach from the head coach on down was, you know, we played pretty well. We're pretty good. We lost. Nothing to get that upset about. We know we're going to clean this up before game four, and we'll be fine. And I just thought, wow, they should be upset because they. I thought as great as Tkachuk was, as clutch as he was in those moments. And by the way, he provided the screen for the goal he didn't score or get an assist on officially in overtime. The game winner.
Yeah,
he's out there. The screen.
He's out there.
He's camped out in front of the goaltender, and they don't move him. So once again, you know, I mean, the Knights sort of let themselves down. I thought they had multiple opportunities, including a crossbar, where they could have, and I would say should have, won that game and gone up 3-0.
Game four of the Stanley Cup Final takes place Saturday, 8 p.m. Eastern, from South Florida. SportsCenter All Night. My name is Chris Lewis. A couple of noteworthy injuries in baseball. Mets say Pete Alonso has a bone bruise and a sprain in his left wrist. Expected to be out 3 to 4 weeks. Been placed on the 15-day injured list in a move retroactive to Thursday. Alonso hit on the left wrist by a pitch, left Wednesday's game against the Braves. Leads the NL in homers with 22 and 49 runs batted in. Also, Astros' Jordan Alvarez on the injured list with an oblique injury. Alvarez was the DH, left Thursday's game against the Blue Jays after a ground out in the first. Alvarez came in hitting .274 with 17 homers and 55 RBIs in 56 games.
Now, the Astros without Alvarez, they were involved in one of the frantic games on a fabulous Friday night in the bigs. Houston at Cleveland turned out to be one of the best games of the season. It read like a basketball game. Five ties, a lot of runs, 19 runs to be exact, 14 innings. But through all that, the Guardians never had the lead until the bottom of the 14th. Walk-off in Cleveland.
A swing and a liner to deep left. Back goes McCormick. It's over his head. Around third, coming home. Freeman scores the winner. Brennan delivers the third walk-off win.
Brennan's first career walk-off hit on WTAM 1100. Guardians 10, Astros 9 in 14 innings. And that wasn't the only walk-off on the day. Phillies and Dodgers played a great one in Philadelphia. Tied at 4 in the ninth, Kyle Schwarber to the plate.
The 1-1 swung on. Hit deep, right field. He's won it. Walk him off, Kyle Schwarber. His fourth career walk-off home run. Kyle Schwarber wins it 5-4 in the bottom of the ninth inning. His 17th home run of the season. And the Phillies have won 6 in a row.
The longest winning streak of the season for the Phillies on Sports Radio 94 WIP. Back-to-back walk-off wins for the Phils. And tune in to baseball action today as the Phillies host the Dodgers. Coverage begins 3:30 p.m. Eastern on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app. Speaking of walk-offs, we are not done on one of the best baseball days of the year. How about the White Sox and Marlins down to the wire?
Swinging a ground ball, fair ball, left field corner. Here comes Elvis. As he touches home plate, the White Sox walk off the Marlins.
That call on ESPN 1000, White Sox 2, Marlins 1. And for the White Sox, their sixth walk-off win of the season. That is the most in Major League Baseball. It is the first four-game home winning streak for Chicago since August through September of 2022. Coming up next, why star power wasn't the deciding factor in Game 4 of the NBA Finals. This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio.
Greeny.
The fact that one of the central pieces feels so much bitterness toward it, it is tragic to me. Makes me feel terribly sad for him.
Weekday mornings at 10 Eastern on ESPN Radio.
Have you seen the cost of eggs lately? With these prices, we'd barely be scraping by if it weren't for Dave. It's the banking app that advances us up to $500 instantly. There's no interest, late fees, or credit checks. No joke. You can get extra cash for anything your family needs. Download the Dave app now or go to Dave.com. For terms and conditions, go to Dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Banking services provided by Evolve, member FDIC.
Netflix, Amazon Prime, HBO, Showtime. Do you feel like your streaming subscriptions are out of control? Why not start the new year off right and cancel the ones you're not using? Enter the Rocket Money app. Rocket Money organizes your subscriptions by due date and notifies you when something is coming up. From there, decide whether to keep it or cancel it with just a tap. To find out more about Rocket Money, go to rocketmoney.com/gameday or download the Rocket Money app from the Apple App or Google Play stores. Rocket Money, the finance app that works for you.
Finally, baseball is back. Swing into the season with tickets to the action. Plus, with basketball and hockey heating up, now is a great time to experience a game. Vivid Seats is proud to be the official ticketing partner of ESPN. From on the glass to in the stands, Vivid Seats has great ticket prices to all the games. Every crack of the bat, every dribble down the court. Catch it all with Vivid Seats. Download the app or visit vividseats.com today. Vivid Seats. Experience it live.
This is it. Enough dreaming about growing my business online. It's time to get serious about selling in my style, as big as I want to grow, because there's nothing I can't do. It's time to get Shopify.
You go and get it.
Oh, oops. I thought I was just talking to myself there. But heck yeah, I do. It's time to take my business to the next level.
Start selling with Shopify to join the commerce platform revolutionizing millions of businesses worldwide. Packed with industry-leading tools ready to ignite your growth, Shopify gives you complete control over your business and your brand. From templates that make site design simple to customizations that let you grow at your pace, this is possibility powered by Shopify. Get a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/play. That's shopify.com/play. Go to shopify.com/play to take your business to the next level today.
Will they find a home? Sponsored by Geico. Sarah wants a yard.
My own little paradise.
Brad, however, hates yard work.
The only thing I hate more than cutting the grass is paying someone to cut the grass.
Compromise is tough, but these two won't have to compromise when they bundle home and car insurance with Geico. It's easy, and they could save even more. In the end, Sarah and Brad found a great home with a yard. A very, very small yard.
Time to get it done. And I'm done.
Bundling without compromise at geico.com.
This is Sports Center All Night. Here's Chris Lewis.
Sports Center All Night. ESPN Radio and the ESPN app is presented by Progressive Insurance. Progressive protects your home, auto, boat, motorcycle, and RV, and could save you money. Visit progressive.com.
Half hour headlines on SportsCenter All Night.
Novak Djokovic beats Carlos Alcaraz to reach the French Open final. Vikings release Dalvin Cook after four straight Pro Bowl seasons. Denver's depth dominance as Nuggets take a commanding lead in the NBA Finals.
The Nuggets are going to dribble out the final 7 seconds. They ceded home court in game two. They come to South Florida and they take two. The Denver Nuggets have won five straight on the road and they're headed home for a chance at their first NBA title. They win game four, 108-95 in Miami. Denver leading 3-1.
One win away from history for the Nuggets, 108-95, the final score. Jamal Murray was a standout playmaker in this one. He had 12 assists. Fourth straight finals game with 10 or more assists. The only player with a streak that long to begin his finals career. 15 points, 12 assists, no turnovers to be exact. He talked about it after the game with Lisa Salters on ABC.
Jamal, that big three on your favorite play when they were making a run in the fourth quarter, how were you able to hold it down when Nikola was on the bench in foul trouble?
How about my teammates? Teammates were great. AG, Kane, Bruce, yo, Jeff came in the game. CB, everybody. Today was a team effort. I can't even name one person. Everybody locked in. We got one more to go.
Tonight you made history, became the first person in NBA history to have at least 10 assists in their first four finals games. What does that mean to you?
Like I said, my teammates. I know you don't get assists without them making shots and making the right reads. So I can't say no. I give all my credit to my teammates. They did a great job. It was a great team effort on both ends, and we got to do that for one more game, and we get our goal.
You started to name names, but I want to single out some guys. Aaron Gordon, describe the impact he had on this game.
He just played with confidence today. You know, he saw one go down, and we just saw him stay aggressive. You know, and he did that, going to the rim, making shots, guarding Jimmy, being on the boards, just, you know, being a force like he was in game one. And, you know, tonight was him.
How about Bruce Brown, his 21 points off the bench?
I mean, Bruce can hoop. Bruce can hoop. Like I said, we got a bunch of guys that can come in the game to impact, and you can't just focus on me or Yoke. You got to guard everybody, and tonight just was another example.
Jamal, you have told us that being on this stage is all you have ever dreamed about as a kid. Now you're one game away from a championship. How do you close this thing out on Monday?
Just stay level-headed, stay focused, and then when we get that dub, then we can relax and we can talk a little.
We'll talk more.
All right,
I'll see you on Monday.
I'll see you Monday.
Doesn't even want to start his mind to think about what it would be like if the team is able to win it on Monday. Jamal Murray. Hey, he made an impact without having the best of shooting nights. Despite that, he and Jokic became the third duo with 500 points and 100 assists in a single postseason. ESPN reporter Brian Windhorst highlighted the impact on SportsCenter.
The Heat threw absolutely everything they knew how at breaking up the Murray-Jokic two-man game. They're double-teaming. They're picking him up as he comes across half-court. At one point, they even fouled him in the backcourt. And they just didn't want Jokic and Murray to beat him. They're bringing a third defender over to try to handle it. And they didn't beat them. Aaron Gordon did. Repeatedly, he was left on smaller defenders, which you know he kills. We saw it earlier in this series. Or he's just sort of on the backside of the play, and they just did the math. They're like, okay, if you're taking this away, we're going to find the open man. They did it. And basically, Eric Spoelstra rolled the dice that the Heat could win the game without the Nuggets role players beating them, and he lost. Aaron Gordon had one of the most important games of his life, 3-1.
Well, the Nuggets, fifth straight road playoff win. That extends the longest streak in franchise history. For the Heat, their fourth straight home playoff loss, their longest streak in franchise history. Our ESPN radio team of BJ Carlissimo, Doris Burke, Mark Kestischer, they had the call, and we get their take on postgame extra.
Chris, thank you very much. Denver Nuggets lost game two on their home floor, lost home court advantage. All they do is come to Miami and win both games three and four. Again, PJ, holding the Heat under 100 points. We don't talk enough about the Denver defense that came through big time to go up 3-1.
Kesty, I couldn't agree with you more. Their defense, this is not a good offensive team. It's a great offensive team. I think the best offensive team in the NBA. They were in the regular season. They've been that or very close to it through the playoffs. They've taken this series to 3-1 with their defense. They've held the Heat 93, 94, 95. I mean, that gives you an incredible opportunity to win. And it doesn't matter. Defense travels. They came down to Miami, did the same thing twice. They're also a complete team. Yeah, they've got two great players that are there night in and night out, but they've had a lot of other guys contribute.
Couldn't be more impressed. And the firm of Brown and Brown off the bench. Yes. Christian Brown in game three and then Bruce Brown in game four were difference makers. Just can't say enough about the performance of Aaron Gordon, who finishes a team high plus 29. I would put it to PJ, your backcourt now with Max Strus and Gabe Vincent, a combined 1-for-10, back-to-back games where Gabe gets in foul trouble. You know, PJ, Duncan Robinson has been a spark for this team. He had 12 points tonight. Kyle Lowry, who was brilliant in the first half, credit the Denver defense. Do you shake things up in this situation with Max Strus having struggled so mightily for every part of this series except the first quarter of game two?
Yeah, I think maybe. I would never be presumptuous enough to suggest something to Eric Spoelstra, but they're down to one loss and you're done. So there's nothing about feelings or anything like that. You just look at the work. It's been consistent. Gabe Vincent played well early, but he's been in foul trouble two games in a row. Max Strus has given him nothing other than that one quarter. And I'm not trying to be harsh. This is the NBA. You're trying to win a championship. Who gives him the best thing? Kevin Love started, but he got 9 quick points in the second half, and there were other guys on the floor who didn't give them a thing. The difference, Michael Malone can look at Michael Porter, who's really been disappointing. KCP been a little disappointing, but he's up 3-1. Right. He doesn't have to change anything. Spo may have to, just all hands on deck. We got to try something different, because to go into that building, now they beat him there the last time, which is really impressive, but over the course of the year, Denver has been great at home.
Don't underestimate the Miami Heat, because all year, and I'll say it again, they were down three to play in the second play-in game. Their season was in the balance. They finished that in a dead sprint and win that game and march their way to the finals. So absolutely incredible guts and grit, and you've got to believe that competitive spirit will be real, Kesty, in game five.
We'll see if Miami can force the series back to South Florida. The Denver Nuggets, 47 years in the NBA, will get their first crack at their first NBA championship Monday night, Ball Arena. You'll hear it here on ESPN Radio. Aaron Gordon, a playoff career high, 27 points. Nikola Jokic turned his ankle early, ends up with 23 points, 12 rebounds, sat 5 minutes in a critical fourth quarter stretch in foul trouble. Bruce Brown off the bench, terrific, 11 fourth quarter points, finished with 21. And the Denver Nuggets have a 3-1 series lead, beating Miami, 108-95 the final, in game four. Now for Doris, PJ, I'm Mark Kestischer right here on your home for the NBA, ESPN Radio, and the ESPN app. Let's go back to Chris Lewis in the studio.
Great stuff from Miami. Now, for the Nuggets, game four might turn out to be the defining game of an era in basketball. Tough loss, though, on the other side for the Heat, but their star, Jimmy Butler, he's keeping a positive attitude as the team heads back to altitude for game five.
Same thing it's always been. It's a game at a time. Now we're in a must-win situation every single game, which we're capable of. Some correctable things that we got to do, but it's not impossible. So we got to go out there and do it. We got three to get.
Game five from Denver Monday night. ESPN Radio's coverage begins 7:30 p.m. Eastern. Tip-off 8:30 p.m. Eastern on ABC, ESPN Radio, and the ESPN app. A rare trade involving an NBA Finals participant. Nuggets acquiring a 2024 first and second pick and a 2023 second round pick in a deal with the Thunder for a protected 2029 first round pick, according to ESPN's Adrian Wojnarowski. SportsCenter All Night, Chris Lewis here on ESPN Radio. Typically, summer break involves going to camp. In football, your summer break is leaving camps, which is exactly what the New York Jets are doing after concluding their offseason work. And while they, in part for now, they do so with a renowned optimism and the new face of their franchise in a happy place, Coley Harvey has more in tonight's SportsCenter report.
From NBA playoff games at the Garden to a concert with a whole lot of Swifties, Aaron Rodgers' first 46 days as a New York Jet have been eventful and have made him feel something he hasn't felt in some time.
It was a lot of fun, actually. The last 6 weeks have been about the most fun I've had in a while.
Not only has he enjoyed his time off the field getting acquainted with his new teammates and new city, but Rodgers says he's been having a blast practicing, even in spite of his injury scare on the first day of OTAs. The calf muscle he tweaked didn't prevent him from participating in a limited capacity in every OTA practice, including Fridays, which officially ended New York's offseason training program and kicked off a month-long break before training camp.
The on-the-field stuff was really important as we start to work through some of the adjustments and signals and just kind of being the other voice in the room with Hack in the installs and in the QB room.
Hack, as in Nathaniel Hackett, the Jets offensive coordinator who comes to the Meadowlands after spending last season as the Denver Broncos head coach. Prior to that, Hackett was Green Bay's offensive coordinator for three seasons, where he helped Rodgers win the 2020 and 2021 MVP awards. Just where is Hackett's Jets offense at this point?
Far away. We've got a lot of work to do. I think the guys have gotten the nuts and bolts of it during this offseason. There's a lot of guys that haven't been out there that we need to see and be able to evaluate and see how they fit in. But there's a lot of work still to be done.
That's coach talk. I like where we're at.
Rodgers also likes the progress he's seen from his backup, embattled previous Jets starter, Zach Wilson.
You know, he hasn't made my life hell every day. He's been a joy to work with, and I give him so much credit because it's a tough situation. The key for him is just, you know, growth and learning, and then kind of building everything back up.
Rodgers says he'll spend a few more days in New York before resuming his individual workouts on the West Coast. In the coming weeks, he hopes to practice there with his pass catchers as they continue honing their timing and chemistry together. I'm Coley Harvey, ESPN.
The Jets have Super Bowl hopes. It was the start of the Super Regionals in college baseball and provided plenty of excitement. One of the Cinderella stories of the tournament, Oral Roberts from the Summit League, they traveled to Eugene to take on Oregon. They built an 8-0 lead. Oregon roared back, tied at 8, bottom of the ninth. The Ducks made a splash.
Line drive, base hit right field. Here comes Rico Nishida.
Oregon took game one, 9-8, largest comeback ever at the Super Regionals. That on ESPN. Another thriller between ACC foes Duke and Virginia in Charlottesville. Unranked Blue Devils stole game one from the seventh-ranked Cavs.
Speed and Storm delivers it out into left field. They're waving into Giacomo from third. Here comes the throw, and Duke takes a 5-4 lead in the eighth, an RBI single from Luke Storm.
That was the final, Duke 5-4. They take game one. Now, speaking of drama between conference opponents, Gainesville hosted a showdown between Florida and South Carolina. The Gators got to celebrate game one at home.
Line base hit. Rivera will score, and it's 5-3 Florida.
Florida wins it 5-4. The other game one of the day saw TCU knock off Indiana State 4-1 in Fort Worth. All Super Regional series are best of three and can be seen on the ESPN family of networks. Coming up next, a historic day for this season in Major League Baseball with the amount of one-run games. We detail that next. This is SportsCenter All Night on ESPN Radio.
Coming up Monday, I'm going to tell you why it's time for the Lakers to stop playing around and make sure they end up with one of these point guards. Monday morning, 6 a.m. Eastern, ESPN Radio, ESPN2, ESPNU.
ESPN Radio Sports Center All Night. More next.
You've never had anything like Kentucky Fried Chicken's new chicken nuggets. They're so good, you'll hear a random choir singing every time you open the box. Don't believe me? Just listen. Box open.
KFC Chicken Nuggets. KFC.
Box close. Open. Close. Can we get a remix? Order KFC's new chicken nuggets on the KFC app today. That's finger looking good. Prices and participation may vary.
MLB fans, when you need tickets to catch your favorite team live all season long, Ticketmaster's got them. As the world's largest ticket marketplace, Ticketmaster has a wide selection of seats available and at competitive prices, so you never have to worry about missing a game. Take yourself out to the ballpark this season and get tickets today at Ticketmaster.com/MLB. That's Ticketmaster.com/MLB. Did you know YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable? That's right. YouTube TV has no long-term contracts or hidden fees, and it even lets you catch up to the live game with key plays. With a lineup of over 100 channels, you can watch live TV like cable. Signing up is simple. Get started in minutes, and you can watch all the action of the NBA Finals live on ABC. So what are you waiting for? Try it free today at youtube.com/NBA23. New users only. Terms apply. Cancel anytime.
Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max.
I speak receiver. He's not excited to be a Raider right now. They cut his guys. Guy goes to New Orleans. He gets the playbook. He's like, man, we getting ready to dink and dunk. We got Jimmy Dale Garoppolo.
GJ and Max.
Rodney in Massachusetts.
Jay, I don't know what it is with you, man. I love you. Then I hate you. Then I love you. Then I hate you again, bro.
Spike Lee, ladies and gentlemen.
Keyshawn, I love you.
Yeah. Are you insane?
GJ and Max. Weekday morning starting at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN2.
Pardon the interruption, but I'm Mike Wilbon in Miami. I got to hustle across town to make it a game three, Tone, so can we do this quickly?
I am Tony Kornheiser.
That's not quick.
I do my best. How's that?
That's not quick.
Is that working for you? How far away is the arena?
Tony, it may be about 4 miles, but it may take an hour and a half. Miami traffic is as bad as anywhere. As bad as Houston, Atlanta, Washington, Chicago, New York, L.A., it may be the worst.
Why don't you rent a bike? Why don't you get one of those bike things on your phone and pedal over there? Welcome to PTI, boys and girls. In today's episode, Rory McIlroy weighs in, Lionel Messi chooses Miami, and baseball cancels games due to smoke. But we begin today with tonight's Game 3 of the NBA Finals. Miami without Tyler Hero, who has been ruled out for tonight, will host Denver with the series tied 1-1. Game 3 may be pivotal. Wilbon, you have already publicly said that Miami will win this game, but which team needs this game more?
They need it the same. I don't buy into that whole notion that somebody needs it more. They're both playing for the same prize, and it's 1-1. So they both need it. And Tony, I think that Miami has an advantage I didn't count on seeing when the series started because I picked the Nuggets in 6, and I'll stay with that. But as I told you on your podcast this morning, there's something about Miami, a toughness, a fight. Like, I know Miami will brawl. Miami's a street fighter, and they're ready to go right now. They're ready to go. Denver may be ready to go, too, but I got to see it. I've seen it from Miami against the Knicks, against the Bucks and against the Celtics, all were who were supposed to be more talented fighters. Denver's supposed to be more talented too.
This is Sports Center All Night. Here's Chris Lewis.
Sports Center All Night on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app, presented by Progressive Insurance. One of the most fun days of the Major League Baseball season, Friday night. And it was extra innings between the Twins and Blue Jays, a one-run game. Twins eke past.
Taylor's got to be thinking about trying to find a way to elevate that ball.
He does swing and hammer one to left field. Playable Merrifield will make the catch. Jeffers will tag. He is heading home. The throw to the plate. The catch and it's dropped by Kurt. Jeffers scores. Lewis makes third. Twins take a 3-2 lead.
Treasure Island Baseball Network. And that was the final. Twins in 10 innings. 3-2 over the Blue Jays. Another one-run game. Braves, Nationals, two NL East teams squaring off. This time it was the Braves, just enough.
Go ahead, run at third. Arcia back up the middle to his left. Abrams can't come up with it, and the Braves take the lead. Arcia with just enough on it to where Abrams went to his left, got leather on it, bobbled it, and by then it was too late. And the comeback kids down there in the first base dugout have come from behind again. It's now 3-2 here in the eighth.
On 680 The Fan, Braves 3, Nationals 2 final. The Nats have lost 5 in a row. Speaking of close baseball games, Orioles Royals down to the wire. Orioles get the one-run win.
Austin Hayes, he's going to open things up in the bottom of the first against Daniel Lynch, the lanky lefty, and this is belted deep left field in the corner. Prado back, he's at the wall, and this ball is fair, and it is gone. One pitch and an Orioles lead. 1-0.
WBAL, Orioles 3, Royals 2. Keeping with the theme, Angels edge the Mariners by the score of 5-4 in a game where Shohei Ohtani hits his 17th home run. And the Cubs edge the Giants 3-2. So if you're following along here, for those counting, that is 9 games in Major League Baseball in one day decided by one run. That is the most one-run games in one night this season. Just a thrilling day. Those one-run games, 3 walk-offs, and a Yankees-Red Sox game as well. Plenty to be excited about in Major League Baseball. Plenty to be excited about with today's top sounds. Here's Steve Lennox.
Number 4.
Chris, a night of walk-offs around Major League Baseball. Let's start in Chicago. Luis Robert delivering in the home ninth inning for the White Sox. The call, ESPN 1000.
Swinging a ground ball, fair ball, left field corner. Here comes Elvis as he touches home plate. The White Sox walk off the Marlins.
Number 3.
Game 4 NBA Finals Friday night in Miami. Aaron Gordon helping the Nuggets to another road victory and a 3-1 lead in the series over the Heat. Kesty, Mark Kestisher, PJ Carlissimo, Doris Burke had the call here on ESPN Radio.
Jamal Murray looks at Michael Malone. Left-hand dribble. Crosses to the right. Back to the left against Duncan Robinson. Drives him. Sends it to Gordon. Corner 3. It's good for Aaron Gordon. 25 for Gordon in game 4.
Third 3. Just playing off his teammates. He's been brilliant.
Number 2.
And Chris, back to the baseball walk-offs in Philadelphia. Dodgers and Phillies tied in the bottom half of the ninth inning. Kyle Schwarber played the role of hero. The call of this walk-off bomb, courtesy of Sports Radio 94 WIP.
The 1-1. Swung on.
Hit deep. Right field. He's won it. Walk him off, Kyle Schwarber.
Number 1.
Astros and Guardians in Cleveland. Bottom of the 14th inning. That's when Will Brennan said, you know what? It's time to go home. Tom Hamilton the call on WTAM 1100.
A swing and a liner to deep left. Back goes McCormick. It's over his head. Around third, coming home. Freeman scores the winner. Brennan delivers the third walk-off win.
Steve Lennox continuing the theme of Major League Baseball, big day for the Diamondbacks. Surprise team of the NL West pounds the Tigers.
2-2. There's the swing. That ball's drilled down the left field line. It's deep to the corner. That ball is gone! First career grand slam for Corbin Carroll. A laser down the left field line. And the Diamondbacks have blown it open. It is 9-2.
Arizona Sports, 98.7 FM. How about 7 runs in the 7th inning for the Diamondbacks? They beat the Tigers 11-6. Struggles continue for the New York Mets. They are doubled up by Pittsburgh.
There's a line drive left field and a base hit. Extra bases for Hayes. It's a 2-run double. The Bucks have put 10 on the board. Hayes is 3-for-3 and has driven in 4.
93-7 the fan. 14-7 Pirates over the Mets. 7th straight loss for the Mets, longest streak since 2019. And New York has allowed 13 runs in consecutive games for the 3rd time in franchise history. Cardinals-Reds close game, but the Cardinals, the team that squeaks by.
Nolan Gorman is 0 for his last 10, and he has struck out all 3 times tonight, but still is dangerous, and he hits that ball high and deep to right, and that is gone. The 3rd 2-run home run of the game for the Cardinals. Gorman hits his 15th, and he is indeed dangerous.
Dangerous indeed on the Cardinals radio network. Cards 7, Reds 4. Padres upend the Rockies 9-6.
Here's the 2-1. Kim waits on it, lines it into center field. Grichuk charging in, won't get there. Has to play it on a hop. Bogarts will come in and score from third base. An RBI single for Ha-Seong Kim. Padres have opened the 5th inning with 3 consecutive hits, and they now lead it 7-1.
The call on 97-3, the fan. Padres get the win 9-6 over the Rockies. 15 hits in the game for San Diego. 4th highest hit total in a game this season. That just about wraps up this edition of SportsCenter All Night. Of course, a couple of thank yous to hand out. Our producer, Jacob Valk, technical director, Javon Cutler, and of course, our ESPN stats and information research team. My name is Chris Lewis. Marty McGee is next here on ESPN Radio.
Coming up Monday, James Harden, Kyrie Irving, CP3, I'll tell you where they all go and what their best landing spots are. Monday morning at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio, ESPN2, and ESPN.
Today on ESPN Radio.
Here's the first one to Freeman, driven well right center field. That one blasted, turning, looking out of here.
Freddie Freeman and the Los Angeles Dodgers storm in the Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia to go head-to-head with Kyle Schwarber and the Phillies.
Schwarber demolishes one.
The Dodgers and Phillies. Coverage begins today at 3:30 Eastern on ESPN Radio. You can also listen on the ESPN app and on your smart speaker.
Have you seen the cost of eggs lately? With these prices, we'd barely be scraping by if it weren't for Dave. It's the banking app that advances us up to $500 instantly. There's no interest, late fees, or credit checks. No joke. You can get extra cash for anything your family needs. Download the Dave app now or go to Dave.com. For terms and conditions, go to Dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Banking services provided by Evolve, member FDIC.
With groceries and housing costs at an all-time high, you're probably looking for new ways to cut costs in the new year. Like, no more trips, restaurants, movies, basically, no more fun. There's a better solution. With Rocket Money, you can track your spending, cancel unwanted subscriptions, and lower your bills. Users save an average of $720 a year. With Rocket Money, you can get your finances back in black, so you don't have to stop doing everything you love to do. To learn more, go to rocketmoney.com/gameday or download the Rocket Money app from the Apple App or Google Play stores.
Finally, baseball is back. Swing into the season with tickets to the action. Plus, with basketball and hockey heating up, now is a great time to experience a game. Vivid Seats is proud to be the official ticketing partner of ESPN. From on the glass to in the stands, Vivid Seats has great ticket prices to all the games. Every crack of the bat, every dribble down the court. Catch it all with Vivid Seats. Download the app or visit vividseats.com today. Vivid Seats. Experience it live.
I'm Andrea, founder of a boutique handbag brand, Andy, and this is why I switched to Shopify. I tried three other platforms prior to Shopify, and I remember my breaking point was when I would try to make one little change and my entire site would go down. Shopify made it really easy for me to shift everything over and hit the ground running. I was easily able to migrate my products and all of my customer information over. With the drag and drop theme editor, we don't need to hire a developer to do any coding. What's amazing is that each theme is automatically optimized on mobile. It's incredible. It looks even better on the phone. We really like adventure. We would not be able to go on the road without a platform that we can rely on. What are you waiting for? Start your free trial with Shopify today. From templates that make site design simple to customizations that let you grow at your pace, this is your possibility powered by Shopify. Get a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com/play. That's shopify.com/play. Go to shopify.com/play to take your business to the next level today.
Will they find a home? Sponsored by Geico. Susan has always wanted to live in a chateau.
I like a certain je ne sais quoi.
While Jake is more into the Cape Cod style home.
It's a classic look.
Compromise is tough, but these two won't have to compromise when they bundle home and car insurance with Geico. It's easy, and they can save even more. In the end, Susan and Jake found a Cape Cod style home where they will only speak French.
Bonjour, je t'aime, merci beaucoup, and cordon bleu.
You'll get better with time.
Bundling without compromise at geico.com.
This is SportsCenter.
Hello there. I'm Mark Robbins. Game four of the NBA Finals. Miami's goal, don't let Nikola Jokic or Jamal Murray beat him. Mission accomplished. Aaron Gordon beat the Heat.
Jamal Murray looks at Michael Malone. Left-hand dribble. Crosses to the right. Back to the left against Duncan Robinson. Drives him. Sends it to Gordon. Corner three. It's good for Aaron Gordon. 25 for Gordon in game four.
Third three. Just playing off his teammates. He's been brilliant.
That's Mark Kestershire. Doris Burke on ESPN Radio. Aaron Gordon had 27 points. A playoff career high. Had 7 rebounds to that. In the 108-95 win, Denver now with a 3-1 lead in the series. Denver star Nikola Jokic knows it was Aaron Gordon's night.
He won us the game. He was our best player on the floor. And, guarding the best player every night, that's not a tough job. And maybe you're not going to get a lot of credit, but we know what he's doing for our team. And we are really thankful for him and appreciate him a lot.
That's Nikola Jokic, Game 5 NBA Finals set for Monday night in Denver, 7:30 p.m. Eastern for the coverage to begin here on ESPN Radio. Major League Baseball Friday in a battle of division leaders, the Rays over the Rangers 8-3. It's Tampa Bay's 7th straight win. Going in the opposite direction, 7 straight losses. Detroit loses to Arizona 11-6. Mets beaten by the Pirates 14-7. Slugger Pete Alonso out 3 to 4 weeks dealing with a bruised wrist.
Coming up Monday, James Harden, Kyrie Irving, CP3. I'll tell you where they all go and what their best landing spots are. Monday morning at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio, ESPN 2, and ESPNU.
Good morning, it's Anna Lynn. If the rooster's crowing, it's time for Marty and McGee.
I've been down the Mississippi, down through New Orleans. Oh, yes, I have.
Oh, thank you, Natalie. It is time for Marty McGee on ESPN Radio, the SEC Network, and the ESPN app presented by Progressive Insurance. You can call us 888-SAY-ESPN. It's 888-729-3776. We got a packed show. We got Mikey C's smoking hot takes coming up. Tom Minks, the monster truck legend, is going to join us on FaceTime. We're going to preview a story that Marty has been working on literally for
8 months.
It's a crazy story from the world of golf and Morgan Hoppin. David DeLucci is going to join us, MLB All-Star, and most importantly, married to a Price is Right legend. And he's going to join us right here in the studio to talk about the fact that college baseball super regionals have started.
Sometimes when you're around other people, you know,
you just can't help but feel super insecure because their handsomeness is so overwhelming.
Yeah.
That's going to be you and me at 9:30.
Yeah. And it makes you mad because DeLucci not only was a Major League All-Star and an Ole Miss baseball legend, and is married to Rachel from Price is Right and has been forever. And she was a all SEC member of the track team at LSU. And then you meet them and they're like the nicest people in the world. And it just makes you mad.
We got
it. Like, you'd like for them to be jerks and they're not.
We got to remember to ask him, the best come on down tale that his wife has shared with him.
She just had like a big anniversary on the show too. Like X number of shows. She's been on the show for like forever. But anyway, yeah, It's David DeLucci will join us to talk about it. By the way, we will get into it. I always wear my minor league baseball caps. I'm wearing, this is from the Eugene Emeralds, and it's got Bigfoot on it, and he's running away. And the reason I wore it is because last night in Eugene, Oregon, the Eugene Emeralds, the minor league team, share the ballpark with the Oregon Ducks right there in Eugene, right on campus, right next to the football stadium.
Did Phil Knight build it?
Yes, as a matter of fact. It is literally almost inside of Alston Stadium. Like, it's in the parking lot. And Oregon has not been to the College World Series since 1954, which was just the fourth year they were in the ballpark that became it. It was so long ago, it wasn't even Johnny Rosenblatt Stadium yet. Johnny Rosenblatt was still the mayor of Omaha. It was Municipal Stadium. That's how long it's been since Oregon's been in the College World Series. Oral Roberts, it was always been great at baseball, only been in the College World Series once in the 1970s. Oral Roberts, 21-game winning streak. And they went to Eugene, Oregon, had an 8-run lead in the middle of the game, lost the game. Man. Oregon came back and won the game.
What's the probability you lose that game?
There is no probability.
0.00000.
In front of it, but it was like one? This season in college baseball, teams were almost 0-100 in games in that situation, down 8 runs in the 6th inning, whatever. And now they're 1-90-something because of what Oregon did.
It's tough to be on that side of that statistic.
Well, what do you do with that? And you've traveled all the way out to Oregon. Eugene's so beautiful, not easy to get to. And so you get all the way out there. You got a chance to make history for your school, and you have an 8-run lead and lose that game. So it will be today. That was the first round of the Super Regionals started. All great games on Friday in the Super Regionals. And we could have as many as 4 teams ready to go for Omaha, half the field, like by the end of tonight. And so, yeah, it's time to go, son.
Which also leads to congratulatory moment for the Oklahoma Sooners.
Yes. Holy cow.
Patty Gasso and her group wins a 3rd consecutive national title in softball. That is her 7th overall as a head coach. And we throw the word dynasty around pretty flippantly anymore for organizations and teams that have sustained success, but it's one thing to have sustained success. It's a whole other thing to actually close the deal and to do it for 3 consecutive years. And I think 6 out of the past 10 is just remarkable. And I'll tell you personally, selfishly, I was really moved by those young ladies in their press conference talking about how their faith is what instills joy within them personally and their collective energy. I just thought that was such an awesome moment to see where kind of they're founded. You know, it was what a special group of people, and congratulations to them and to Florida State. I mean, those girls battled, and what an awesome season they had as well. Congratulations to all of them to be on that stage. I think about that stage, man, especially in softball right now, where it's been elevated to this place because the product is so fun to watch, that there's more pressure on these young ladies than ever. And I know that because I've actually talked to Coach Gasso about it, and that they want joy and peace in their lives. And there's all these inputs from social media that they're all experiencing and navigating. And so to be that great on that stage in this moment with so much riding on it, is wonderful. So congratulations to Oklahoma.
Here are the numbers for Oklahoma this season. 61-1. They won 53 straight games to close out the season. 500 runs scored for the 3rd straight season, which is a record. 2nd team in the history of softball to win 3 straight national titles. UCLA in the 1988 through 1990. It is just, and show no signs of slowing down. And oh, by the way, opening like a $47 million home softball facility next year, and most of the team is back. So
I texted McGee.
They're in good shape.
I texted McGee Thursday. Thursday, maybe.
We text all the time. What text was this?
I was working out, and I had the softball game on the.
Yeah.
It might have been.
No, it was early. It was like.
It was Thursday because they won Friday, right? No. What? It doesn't matter.
Whatever. Middle of the week.
Game one. I was watching the first game between Oklahoma and Florida State, and I was working out, and I stopped my workout to go over and text homeboy over here. Dude, I'm watching this game like my life depends on
it. It's Oklahoma Stanford. Oklahoma Stanford, and it's like 1-0 because Stanford had a chance to win the game.
What an awesome game.
And it was so tight. And and Marty texts me. He goes, I'm watching this game like my life depends on it. I said, yeah. No, but that's there is an intensity. Listen, the postseason is the postseason. We've seen it in the Stanley Cup Finals this week. We've seen it in the NBA Finals last night. There's an intensity level in the playoffs in any postseason that's just – it's just different. But in softball, where everything happens so fast and the quarters are so close, it just feels more intense. And by the way, props to – I mean, the entire production team, they took a picture on the field – in Oklahoma City yesterday as they were about to leave. Our colleagues from ESPN, led by the great legendary Meg Aronowitz, what they do for that game is just the game of softball. It's crazy. But it is, we say it on the show all the time, it's made for television. College softball and college gymnastics, there's nothing, there are no better sports on television. If you don't care a thing about sports, I live in a house with two other people who really don't care about any of this. And they will stop what they're doing to watch softball because there's an energy level to it that it just is, it's bonkers. I've been to the stadium in Oklahoma City. I've been to some big college softball games. Never been to Women's College World Series. I go to Omaha every year. I need to figure out a way to get to Oklahoma City.
How does it make everyone feel that Oklahoma's coming to the SEC?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, you know, and meanwhile,
I bet it makes Greg Sankey happy.
Well, last year at the Men's College World Series, half the field were SEC schools, and then Oklahoma and Texas were both there.
Gosh.
So six of the eight were either, SEC schools or and in the men's tournament, the SEC will have a minimum of two teams in the College World Series. Could have as many as four again, and Texas is still in the mix too. So, yeah. It's going to be interesting. And Greg Sankey did a lot of media this week talking about the future.
He did. I mean, it's wild right now. The future in so many sports.
They're all in Washington, which is always, how I feel about politics. Our friend Mike Leach said it to us. He goes, I guess Congress is going to have to figure out this NIL thing. He goes, when have they ever fixed anything? He said it on our show.
And he's right.
Yeah.
And on top of that, I do think that that's where we are. I think that Congress is going to have to have, pass legislation that creates uniform parameters for NIL and the portal and all that mess, because they are very much intertwined.
Yeah.
And the way it's all unfolded is, it's like, I mean, Nick Saban's Nostradamus. He said unintended consequences. He's the first person that I ever heard use that term.
Yeah.
And the unintended consequences are overwhelming, which leads us to PGA Tour.
Oh, yeah.
Well, and the Public Investment Fund.
Yeah. And that's where we're going to go next.
Holy.
I've been dying to talk to you about this all week long. I've not talked to you about it because you were in the middle of a huge project and I was in the middle of a bunch of other stuff. And I was like, you know what? We'll save it for the show.
Yeah. I mean, it can be the whole show today.
LIV. PGA, WTH. It's Marty McGee on ESPN Radio, the SEC Network, and the ESPN app.
WTF.
Mornings with KJ and Max.
My damn ankles and my shins hurt, so I hiked 10 miles over the weekend. So
why?
I mean, it hurts.
They got them, right, Yates?
Max, we lost another one.
Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max. Weekday morning starting at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN2.
You can't miss a moment with Greeny.
Have I sort of overdone it on the Aaron Rodgers stuff?
Remember when Mike Tannenbaum suggested that the Jets take a quarterback and you almost smacked him in the face?
I mean, I think my reaction to that was startlingly restrained. It's a miracle, I think, that I did not lay hands on that man.
I wish they did that.
The most insane thing I've ever heard a person say in my entire life, but he and I are no longer speaking.
Greeny. Weekday mornings at 10 Eastern on ESPN Radio. Plus, you can watch and listen on the ESPN app. Chris Canty and Chris Carlin are Canty and Carlin.
Talking to two-time Super Bowl champ Damian Woody. Damian, I need you to help me out because I have a big problem. My parents have been up here visiting with me and my wife for the last 2 weeks. Now, this wasn't for leisure or vacation. My dad had a surgical procedure, so they just went back home to Charlotte, North Carolina. Now, my mom is having her retirement party. My question to you is this. How much time is too much time with your in-laws? Because my wife has been subjected to my parents for the last 2.5 weeks. Her and my dad are cool. Her and my mom, not necessarily out of eyes. As a husband, how do I smooth things over with my wife and my mama spending so much time around each other?
Bro, you're going to have to do something for your wife. She's going to cash in those chips for having the in-laws in town for that period of time. You, my friend, are in trouble.
Canty and Carlin, weekdays at 3 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on the ESPN app. ESPN's College Game Day, the podcast.
College football being so wed to tradition has held it back, and the bowl system, to me, has been that. Now, look, I'm a bowl guy. I watch bowls. I'm just like pro smart business for college athletics as it's pushing forward. When these dudes make the playoff, they don't care that there's some guy in a yellow jacket reading the results. Like, this is a cool-blooded billion-dollar business.
Listen to the College Game Day podcast with Reese Davis and Pete Thamel wherever you listen to podcasts.
The classic Kentucky Fried Chicken sandwich, crispy chicken, 100% white meat with crunchy pickles and mayo. It might just be the best KFC chicken sandwich.
Oh, don't forget KFC spicy chicken sandwich. It brings the heat.
Also very good.
Topped with a kick of spicy mayo, it might just be the best.
One of the best.
Okay, one of the best KFC chicken sandwiches out there.
Agreed.
Oh, yeah.
Choose your flavor with KFC's chicken sandwich in classic
or spicy.
That's finger licking good. Price participation may vary.
MLB fans, when you need tickets to catch your favorite team live all season long, Ticketmaster's got them. As the world's largest ticket marketplace, Ticketmaster has a wide selection of seats available and at competitive prices, so you never have to worry about missing a game. Take yourself out to the ballpark this season and get tickets today at Ticketmaster.com/MLB. That's Ticketmaster.com/MLB. Did you know YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable? That's right. YouTube TV has no long-term contracts or hidden fees, and it even lets you catch up to the live game with key plays. With a lineup of over 100 channels, you can watch live TV like cable. Signing up is simple. Get started in minutes, and you can watch all the action of the NBA Finals live on ABC. So what are you waiting for? Try it free today at youtube.com/NBA23. New users only. Terms apply. Cancel anytime.
Exclusively on ESPN Plus, UFC 289, tonight. Welcome to my house. Amanda Nunes,
the greatest of all time,
defends her bantamweight title against Arayne Aldana. And Charles Oliveira takes on Beneil Dariush in a pivotal lightweight bout. UFC 289, tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern. Buy it on ESPNplus.com/PPV.
Here's Bruce Brown for three. It's good. What a night for Bruce Brown. The Denver Nuggets have won 5 straight on the road.
Don't listen to everybody telling you how great you are, because we haven't done a damn thing yet. We have to win another game to be world champions.
And I know what they say, money can't buy everything. Well, maybe so, but it can buy me a boat.
And we're back. It's Marty McGee on ESPN Radio, the SEC Network, and the ESPN app presented by Progressive Insurance. Tune in to the NBA Finals. Game 5 Monday night as the Nuggets look to close out the Heat on their home court. Coverage begins at 8 p.m. on ABC. And you can also listen on ESPN Radio. And by the way, you can join us 888-SAY-ESPN. It's 888-729-3776. And you know what? We got a caller on hold right now. Bud in Tennessee is on the line. Bud, what's going on?
Come on.
How y'all gentlemen doing today?
Good, man.
First of all, I want to tell you, if you go to Omaha, the best place to eat, they claim Omaha's got them great steaks. The best steaks are at the casinos across the river in Council Bluffs, Iowa. I live in front of the Powerhouse in Nebraska City, and I enjoyed I eat all them steak places up there, and I enjoyed the ones in Council Bluffs across the river more than I did the one in Omaha. And they ain't near as pricey either.
Okay. I know all about the steaks at the casino in Council Bluffs.
Over to Harris.
I went and saw Eric Church play there many moons ago before he was chief.
I was going to say, this was before he was selling out Nissan Stadium.
Days, and that was back, you know, I had young kids, and he didn't have no kids yet, and he was a nocturnal beast. And we'd drink till about 4 o'clock in the morning after his show, and then I'd be up at 8.
Yeah.
He'd sleep till 4:30 in the afternoon.
Right.
And he'd be like, hey, man, what you been doing?
You're like, I've been working out, waiting on you.
Eating one of them Omaha steaks. All right, bud, what you got?
I wanted to ask you, did you know how you feel like Tennessee got shafted this week, having to go to Hattiesburg instead of playing in Knoxville? I ain't caring about that at all. And when the NCAA goes out of business in about 5 years and all everything is concerned around the SEC, they could sell them buildings to the NAIA. Only just a little heads up for me, because I think we got shafted.
Yeah, I mean, I get it. I mean, I just
I haven't heard a why yet because they had to go on the road. Is that the
because
point?
Because they have to go on the road. Okay, they got to go to Hattiesburg.
I got
yeah, and honestly, if Tennessee had taken care of their business, you know, middle of the season, this wouldn't even be a discussion because they would have had a national seed and they would have hosted it. I get it, but I totally understand. Here's the thing. Listen, I'm going to talk to my Tennessee people because I love y'all. I just spoke at graduation. I've got a Tennessee sticker on the back of my truck. But if the fan base spent half as much time focusing their energy on just getting ready for games as they do figuring out a way that everybody got shafted by the NCAA or whoever, it's just the chasing the anger is exhausting. You know what I mean? Like, you just take care of your business. You know, the reason that Tennessee fell on its face in Omaha 2 years ago, and quite honestly, last year the number one seed didn't even make it to Omaha, was because you can watch this shift in focus to stuff that doesn't matter anymore. You know, when I watched the coach throw the clipboard and guys getting thrown out of games and this and that, so in the game when they were eliminated in Knoxville 2 years ago, you could feel it in the building. It was like, they've downshifted now. They're not even focusing on the game anymore. Like, they have still a chance to win the game. And I just, there's a thing that happens, and there's an energy shift that happens that I just, you know, maybe I'm a little sensitive because everybody's been wearing me out all week about Tennessee's getting screwed. You know what? Just take care of your deal. Just go on the road, you know, win your super regional and go to Omaha. But quit worrying about what you did or didn't get and all that. You know, the flip side of this is Indiana State, right? Indiana State, a national seed. And they take care of business in a really, really difficult regional. And even as a national seed, they're not hosting this weekend. They've got to go to TCU. They lost last night in game one. TCU is one of the most difficult places to play in all of college baseball. The reason is because Indiana State University has hosted the Indiana Special Olympics for 51 years. There was nowhere that they did not have the facility available. They did not have the personnel available. And instead of, it is not fair. I mean, for the baseball team, you should have been hosting, but it's just the circumstances are what they are. Now you got to go to TCU. And what happened was, all right, we're just going to go. And the Indiana State fans are a ton of them went down to Fort Worth. And the TCU fans felt kind of guilty about it. And they've raised thousands of dollars for the Indiana Special Olympics this week. Just turn it into a positive. It's cool. Just take care of your business. You're Tennessee. You have been on the road in the most difficult environments of college baseball. You're there all the time. You go to LSU. You go to South Carolina. You go to all these places. You go to Ole Miss. You go to Mississippi State. Just don't worry about it. Just go take care of your business and focus. You didn't get screwed. It is what it is. Is that?
I'm out. I'm all in.
Yeah, I
completely agree.
Focus on the games. It is what it is. You can be unhappy about it, but just enough. So there you go. That's what I want to say.
Well said.
Yeah. I just, by the way, one cool thing at Southern Miss was they had a priest walking through the stands yesterday, like throwing blessings on the home ballpark.
Really?
Yeah.
Like Kyrie Irving at time on the baseline?
Yeah. One of the beat writers, and I'm sorry, I don't have the name. One of the beat writers was looking out of the press box just there getting set up for the weekend. There's a priest going through the stands in Hattiesburg throwing up.
What do you think he's saying?
Right, up and down. I don't know.
I'd like to know that.
I would like to know that. I posted that. I retweeted the guy, and I can't tell you how many Joe Boo responses I got.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there was a big string on the social media about what baseball movie. What's the first baseball movie that comes to mind for you? And mine's Major League because it's one of my favorites of all time. And
yeah.
There's never been a movie with more or better one-liners. It's just loaded with them. Yeah. And so there became this whole string of Major League one-liners. And, of course, one of the greatest ever is up your butt, Joe Boo.
Yeah. That was when I wrote it in the Welcome to the Circus Baseball, which, by the way, we're going to talk about your book coming up for this fall. But I write about it, about the fact that the actor who played three actors from came up hung at a ballpark, but one of them was Eddie from Major League, and he comes kind of sneak up, and they were shooting Richie Rich. He comes sneak up in the top row and sit up there and drink beer, and every time we'd see him, we would start.
What's his name? Kelsey something?
Kelsey Ross.
Yeah.
Chelsea Ross. Yep. And he was so cool. But all summer long, you know. In fact, that summer of Major League 2 came out.
I mean, Eddie yeah. Harris
yeah.
had so many yeah. great lines in that movie yeah. from.
How many times have I said to you when we're on the road in the fall, have I looked at you and said, bartender, Joe Boone needs a refill.
Yeah.
As a rum drinker, I'm contractually obligated.
You trying to tell me Jesus Christ can't hit a curveball?
Get the Crisco.
All right, Harris, let's not start a holy war.
Crisco all over his chest.
Crisco. Bar doll. And if the humps are watching you real close, McGee. Just rub a little jalapeno in your nose.
GJ and Max.
They told him when they traded for him, you come over here from Green Bay, Carr's your guy. We're going to push the ball down the field. Then they ship his guy off. He gets the playbook. He's like, man, we getting ready to dink and dunk. Of course he's going to be unhappy.
More from Keyshawn, Jable, and Max. Weekday mornings at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN2.
Caleb Williams is going to be the number one overall pick in this coming season. He has leverage to say to the NFL, no thanks. Not to the whole league, but to whoever is there who might want to draft him.
Check out the Dominique Foxworth Show, anywhere you get your podcast.
How rare is it, Tim, to have the type of personality where your appetite for yeah. shots is such that if I don't get them, I'm good with that? I would think that's difficult to do.
Extremely. And there's a reason they targeted him specifically to join this group. He was the perfect addition when they picked up Aaron Gordon for that exact reason. Mm-hmm. He's a guy that put up big numbers on some nights in Orlando. Right? At nights, he had to be the guy in Orlando as their focal point of their offense. But now you look at what he's had to do since he got to Denver, he absolutely is going to take what's available to him on a given night and be satisfied to do that. Because when guys play like this, what they're telling you first and foremost, because they say it all the time, it's all about winning. This is actually backing it up. When you yeah. play the way that he does and accept that from night to night, your shot chart and your field goal attempt line on that box score, it could look dramatically different depending on how things break for you in that game. But Scott, I think if any game epitomized who this group is as a team, mm-hmm. it was this game. Your stars don't play great offensively, but yeah. still very impactful. You always need that third guy to have a big night, whoever that may be. Tonight it was him. But then look at, you know, what you get from Bruce Brown tonight. Look at,
sure,
Jamal Murray talked about that three, Jeff Green, and he took one shot.
Yep.
It was enormous, a corner three.
KCP, 6-9, yeah.
KCP, biggest defensive play of the game, a double strip on Jimmy Butler in the lane in a six-point game mm-hmm. that leads to a transition layup going the other way. So, and then, you know, we talked about what Christian Brown did in the last game.
Yep.
This is a team, and Jamal Murray was referencing that a lot in his post-game sound.
Have you seen the cost of eggs lately? With these prices, we'd barely be scraping by if it weren't for Dave. It's the banking app that advances us up to $500 instantly. There's no interest, late fees, or credit checks. No joke. You can get extra cash for anything your family needs. Download the Dave app now or go to Dave.com. For terms and conditions, go to Dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Banking services provided by Evolve, member FDIC.
Netflix, Amazon Prime, HBO, Showtime. Do you feel like your streaming subscriptions are out of control? Why not start the new year off right and cancel the ones you're not using? Enter the Rocket Money app. Rocket Money organizes your subscriptions by due date and notifies you when something is coming up. From there, decide whether to keep it or cancel it with just a tap. To find out more about Rocket Money, go to rocketmoney.com/gameday or download the Rocket Money app from the Apple App or Google Play stores. Rocket Money, the finance app that works for you.
Shopify presents cool sheets from AHA to
lying awake while you bake isn't cool. I suffered from the wrong kind of hot in bed, heat-induced insomnia. That was my AHA moment, bed sheets that keep you cool. Then I thought, how do I even sell bed sheets? That's when I had the idea that made it all possible, signing up on Shopify. With the help of Shopify's intuitive online store creator, I started selling sustainable bamboo sheets that keep cool year-round. And my cool idea became a reality. Hot sleepers around the world rejoice. Shopify makes it simple to keep your cool while starting and growing your business. Start selling with Shopify today and join the commerce platform powering millions of businesses worldwide. From AHA to anything is possible.
This is Possibility, powered by Shopify. Start selling online today. Sign up for a free trial at shopify.com/play. Shopify.com/play.
This is SportsCenter.
Hello there. I'm Mark Robbins. The Denver Nuggets pull away from the Miami Heat in the fourth quarter on Friday, winning game four of the NBA Finals 108-95. Aaron Gordon leading the Denver offense with a playoff career high of 27 points. Denver wins its fifth straight on the road during the postseason, and now the Nuggets stand one win in their first NBA title. Denver star Jamal Murray on the team's mindset and attitude.
We're just ready to win a championship. We have the tools to do it. It's been on our minds for a while, so we're just locked in. I don't think you got to overthink it. We're just dialed in, ready to win.
Simple. It's Jamal Murray. Game five of the NBA Finals set for Monday night, 7:30 p.m. Eastern, for the coverage to begin right here on ESPN Radio. Major League Baseball on Friday, the winning reaches seven in a row for the squad that already has the best record in the game.
Swing and a drive, deep to left, to the corner. Gone! Isak Paredes four, and the Rangers one.
All the fun on 620 WDAE in Tampa. The Rays win at 8-3 and now stand 47-19 on the season. Couple of walk-offs on Friday. Phillies take care of the Dodgers 5-4 and Kyle Schwarber's solo home run of the ninth. And in 14 innings, Cleveland over Houston 10-9, while the White Sox walk off the Marlins. The final in that one, 2-1. Game four, Stanley Cup Finals coming up tonight. Vegas leads Miami 2-1.
Coming up Monday, I'm going to tell you why it's time for the Lakers to stop playing around and make sure they end up with one of these point guards. Monday morning, 6 a.m. Eastern, ESPN Radio, ESPN2, ESPNU.
It's time for Mikey C's Smoking Hot Sports Takes on Marty and McGee.
Yeah. Time for Mikey C's Smoking Hot Sports Takes. Mikey C, what you got, son?
Boy, speaking of smoking hot sports takes, we had the smoke up here for a little bit. I don't know if you guys caught it. Yeah, it kind of felt like Aquaman in the ocean, though. It didn't bother me one bit.
We had it down here, and then I was kind of whining about it, and then all my friends from New York started sending me pictures. I quit whining about it because it was like down here you could smell it. There was a little bit of a haze, but up there it looked like orange. It was crazy.
They
crazy
said it was the equivalent of smoking six cigarettes going out there for like 2 hours. Right?
Everybody so else is coughing and you're fine.
Yeah. It didn't bother me one bit. All right.
He said he felt like
Ladies
Aquaman.
And gentlemen, please welcome to the stage DJ Lundard.
He said he felt like Aquaman because everybody else was struggling. He's like, what? I'm just walking around.
All right. Well, the NBA Finals last night, the Denver Nuggets moved one step closer to winning the NBA Finals. If you remember, one of my hot takes was Denver in five. So I'm going to stick with that and say Denver will close out the NBA Finals Monday night on their home court.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know how you dispute it, because when Jokic went out with his fifth foul last night, the Heat went on a heater. How about that? They went on a heater. But ultimately, the Nuggets were able to thwart it, and Aaron Gordon played out of his mind. He had a tremendous game. It's why he came there and why the organization really wanted him to come there a couple of years ago. He's been not just a contributor, but he's been a difference maker for Denver. And I don't disagree. I actually said I thought Denver in six, but they certainly do seem to have a ton of momentum. I mean, Jokic is just
And then what he's doing
is historic.
And the fact they did what they did when he was in, had the five fouls, that's scary. If you, by the way, when I say Denver Nuggets, like, what's the first player that pops in your head?
Kind of two at the same time. Alex English, number one,
right.
And Mahmoud Abdul-Raouf, number two.
Yeah.
And people forget, like, Melo played in Denver. AI played in Denver.
Dikembe Mutombo, obviously. But Alex English is the guy. I immediately see the 1980s uniforms, 70s uniforms with the funky font and the whole deal. But David Thompson played there for a couple of years. They won an ABA title. When I was a kid, they'd come to Charlotte. They played the Carolina Cougars. But Alex English, by the way, University of South Carolina, but just 90 minutes down the road to Dreher High School. He should be in the Hall of Fame, by the way. But it's like a 9-time All-Star.
Brad Doherty, our great friend and former colleague here at the Worldwide Leader. Brad posted a photo on social media the other day of the 1986 rookie class for Cleveland Cavaliers.
Yeah.
And in the photo with him is Ron Harper, whom I adore. I love every time I see Ron, I wear him out about MJ stories, of course.
Yeah.
But, dude, Ron's shorts. I replied to Brad's Twitter. I said, son, we got to be careful, man. It's a family show. Ron's. Yeah. Yeah. Harp shorts much, are so short, they're not suitable for work.
It's too much information. Yeah.
This is a family program here, bud.
But I immediately think Alex English and that cool it's like the NBA version of the Houston Astros, like, multicolored tiered jersey was that Denver Nuggets jersey that had the funky font with the skyline that had the different colors in it. The Nuggets were not good, but those jerseys were awesome. All right, sorry, Mike, you see, we started talking.
I remember being a kid, I would always get basketball cards. I would always get Fat Lever cards. It seemed like every pack had a Fat Lever card. If he was an All-Star, I would have been rich with Fat Lever.
We had a great legendary producer at ESPN, Michael Lever. We called him Fat because it was because of Fat Lever with the Denver Nuggets.
All right, one of the other big news stories this week, of course, was the merger you guys mentioned between the PGA and LIV Golf. As a golf fan, I kind of felt like the PGA was telling these guys, be loyal, don't take the money. And then it seems like they took the money. So for me, it's going to be kind of hard to watch the PGA Tour this year, upcoming season. What do you guys have to say about it?
It won't be hard for me, man. I love watching golf so much. But this has been, I mean, the second that it happened around 10 o'clock in the morning on Tuesday, my phone just was blowing up.
With actual golfers, by the way. Like the rest of us, it was your friends. For Marty, it was like, you know.
It was just kind of wild. You know, nothing shocking anymore, but that decision was. And it's because of all of the consistent narrative from Jay Monahan, the PGA Tour commissioner, from players who chose to stay, some of the players, certainly not all. But specifically Jay Monahan, of venom spit towards LIV and what they were doing and what they were enabling as a result of going to LIV and whatnot by aligning with the Saudis. And then all of a sudden, I mean, these two guys show up on CSNBC and they are telling us that they are unifying golf with they're unifying the PGA Tour, LIV, and the DP World Tour. And you just sit there and, like, I mean, I went, holy bleep.
Come.
The thing about it is there's so many unknowns right now. And it feels like every 10 or 15 minutes, one of the beat writers in golf releases a new story with more information, whether it be from Jimmy Dunn, who was really the catalyst and spearhead on the PGA Tour side for making this happen. Mr. Dunn is a Augusta National member. He is widely, if not universally, respected throughout the sport, and was really a catalyst here. And Sports Illustrated did a phenomenal piece interviewing Mr. Dunn about the intricate details of this deal.
Slaybaugh did too. Mark Slaybaugh had a great piece on ESPN.com where he laid out this equity plan where PGA golfers can
proposed
be involved in
equity plan.
Right.
Look, we don't know nothing yet because right. If you just look at it, I'm no lawyer. I'm not ever going to portend or pretend to be. I don't know law, but I know this much. I've seen enough written right now from people that know better than I do that there's great potential this never happens.
Yeah.
Because of antitrust.
Sure.
And I mean, I don't know if it's going right. to, if it is or is not going to happen, but I know this. Money wins.
No, it's the only and reason they're doing any of this.
The PGA Tour could never outlast the PIF in court because the PIF could take this thing till the end of time and the PGA Tour can't. And so they had to figure out, okay, what is the best way to make sure that we have longevity? And even like my sort of North Star on this is Rory McIlroy, who to me is, he called himself, I can't help but feel a little bit like a sacrificial lamb.
He is.
And
that guy sold out. He was sold out.
He put the PGA Tour on his back like a backpack.
And he was sold out.
And he climbed up Everest with the PGA Tour on his back.
Yeah.
And he was exhausted with it. He played really well, so he was able to mask the exhaustion until Augusta when he missed the cut.
Yeah.
That was a line of demarcation for Rory McIlroy. I'm exhausted with this. And then for this to happen, I can see in his face and in his words that he is trying his dead level best to say, okay, for the financial longevity of the tour, maybe this is the best case that we can find. But that don't mean he likes it. I mean, he said, and I quote, "I still hate Liv. I hope Liv dies."
Well, they no longer can trust the commissioner of the PGA. Can't trust him. You can't trust him. And I don't care what the situation was. I don't care what the impending lawsuits are going to be. I don't care. So to answer Mikey's question, will I still be able to watch golf? Yes, I will still be able to watch golf. But every single time, and I don't know Jay Monahan. I've talked to him once in my life. Every single time he sits at the podium, I'm turning the television off because I'm not going to believe anything he says. Because at the end of the day, you cannot invoke 9/11. You can't do it. And then be shocked that everyone's mad at you because you're doing business with the people that you literally invoked the greatest single tragic day of our lifetimes. And you invoke that multiple times to try to explain why we should have all drawn a moral line between us and them. And then all of a sudden you are announcing that you're going into business with the people that you convinced us was them. And now all of a sudden we're supposed to be cool with it. So the reality is that, and oh, by the way, based on everything the players said, most of the players said they had no clue. And just to do all of that. And now his whole explanation, his narrative is, well, I erred on the side of caution and I erred on the side of discretion and I shouldn't have done that. If anyone tells you they trust him from this point on forward, they're lying to you. No one should trust him. No one. And it's just this. And the good news is he can go to bed on a big old pile of money and that's fine. And maybe he's cool with that. But the reality is that he sold him out. He spent all the rhetoric. Again, you cannot invoke 9/11. You can't do it. You cannot do it. And then back up of all the things in the world that you could talk about as to why we should believe this or why this player should go do this. And you don't turn your back on us or whatever else. 9/11. You can't do it. You can't. It's the one thing I can come up with that you can't do it. Guess what?
Have you ever had an opinion or took a stance on something based on the information you had in the moment? And then later on, circumstances shifted.
Yeah.
Where you were forced to maybe alter your perspective and go a different direction.
Yeah.
That is what he is saying happened.
Right. And whatever.
That is what he is saying happened. He is saying that he said, look, I can see how people look at me and call me a hypocrite, which of course, everybody views him that way right now.
Right.
I don't give a hoot what side of the fence you're on, if you're standing on the fence or you're all the way this way or all the way that way, the vast majority of people look at him right now and say, that guy's a hypocrite.
Yeah. All and will the rest of his life. It's always what we always talk about as writers. What are they going to write about you when they do your obituary? What they're going to lead with? And what they're going to lead with is this.
Yeah, it's always interesting. Like we don't know anything yet. We don't know what's going to happen or how this is going to unfold or what it really means for professional golf. And where I am with it from the fundamentals is, and I don't know law yet. Well, I don't know law well enough yet to really be able to analyze this. But on the surface, it sure looks like the Saudis bought golf.
Yeah.
Again, if you're a lawyer and you can call in here and tell us what your perspective is on what really happened here, great, call us.
They got outflanked. They got turned around sideways and they got outflanked. But do not, going forward, sell us anymore. This them trying to tell us this is about the unification of golf and 10 years from now this is no different than what Phil Mickelson was saying was getting ripped for a year ago. Oh, I'm doing this for the betterment of golf. No, you're not. You're doing it for money. And if you're the PGA Tour, we're doing this, we're going to unify. No, you're not. You're doing it for money. You're doing this because the bottom line forced your hand or because there's just too much money to ignore. It's just, but don't sell us on this is, we're doing all this for the betterment of the game. No, you're not. You're doing all this for the betterment of you. And that's fine. It's a business. It's a business first and foremost. But don't, the optics matter. And don't sell us on, we're doing this because, you know, this is great for the game. Sure, fine. It's great for the game. But don't tell us that was the primary motivation. It's not. If you're saving your butt or you're trying to make money, and those two things are mutually, those things are tied together, that's what the hell you're doing. So just don't, don't talk to us like we don't know what the hell's going on.
Always follow the money.
It's Marty McGee on ESPN Radio, the SEC Network, and the ESPN app.
Today on ESPN Radio.
Blasted, turning, looking out of here.
Freddie Freeman and the Los Angeles Dodgers storm in the Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia to go head-to-head with Kyle Schwarber and the Phillies. Coverage begins today at 3:30 Eastern on ESPN Radio. You can also listen on the ESPN app and on your smart speaker.
MLB fans, when you need tickets to catch your favorite team live all season long, Ticketmaster's got them. As the world's largest ticket marketplace, Ticketmaster has a wide selection of seats available and at competitive prices, so you never have to worry about missing a game. Take yourself out to the ballpark this season and get tickets today at Ticketmaster.com/MLB. That's Ticketmaster.com/MLB.
Will they find a home? Sponsored by Geico. Susan has always wanted to live in a chateau.
I like a certain je ne sais quoi.
While Jake is more into the Cape Cod style home.
It's a classic look.
Compromise is tough, but these two won't have to compromise when they bundle home and car insurance with Geico. It's easy, and they can save even more. In the end, Susan and Jake found a Cape Cod style home where they will only speak French.
Bonjour, je t'aime, merci beaucoup, and cordon bleu.
You'll get better with time.
Bundling without compromise at geico.com.
Finally, baseball is back. Swing into the season with tickets to the action. Plus, with basketball and hockey heating up, now is a great time to experience a game. Vivid Seats is proud to be the official ticketing partner of ESPN. From on the glass to in the stands, Vivid Seats has great ticket prices to all the games. Every crack of the bat, every dribble down the court. Catch it all with Vivid Seats. Download the app or visit vividseats.com today. Vivid Seats. Experience it live. Did you know YouTube TV is more than cable for less than cable? That's right. YouTube TV has no long-term contracts or hidden fees, and it even lets you catch up to the live game with key plays. With a lineup of over 100 channels, you can watch live TV like cable. Signing up is simple. Get started in minutes, and you can watch all the action of the NBA Finals live on ABC. So what are you waiting for? Try it free today at youtube.com/NBA23. New users only. Terms apply. Cancel anytime.
You've never had anything like Kentucky Fried Chicken's new chicken nuggets. They're so good, you'll hear a random choir singing every time you open the box. Don't believe me? Just listen. Box open.
KFC Chicken Nuggets. KFC.
Box close. Open.
Original recipe and ready. KFC.
Close. Can we get a remix? Order KFC's new chicken nuggets on the KFC app today. That's finger looking good. Prices and participation may vary.
Today on ESPN Radio.
Here's the first one to Freeman, driven well right center field. That one blasted, turning, looking out of here.
Freddie Freeman and the Los Angeles Dodgers storm in the Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia to go head-to-head with Cal Schwarber and the Phillies.
Schwarber demolishes one.
The Dodgers and Phillies. Coverage begins today at 3:30 Eastern on ESPN Radio. You can also listen on the ESPN app and on your smart speaker. Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max.
Keith, can you consider the Chiefs a dynasty already?
It's close. I think you need three. They've done a lot in a short amount of time. One more will solidify it in my book, but it's hard to argue that they've been to the Super Bowl. They won, they lost, they won. You know, it's hard. One more, though. One more, and I think most people dive all the way in.
Keith, J., and Max. Mornings on ESPN Radio and on the ESPN app. Greedy.
The fact that one of the central pieces feels so much bitterness toward it, it is tragic to me. Makes me feel terribly sad for him.
Weekday mornings at 10 Eastern on ESPN Radio.
Sure enough, that ain't my truck in her drive. And this ain't my day tonight. Looks like she's in love and I'm out of love. That ain't my shadow.
Morning McGee on ESPN Radio, the SEC Network, and the ESPN app. Presented by Progressive Insurance. You can call us at 888-SAY-ESPN. It's 888-729-3776. We've got some callers on hold. We're going to get to you. We got a little worked up there on Mikey C's smoking hot sports takes.
Well, it's just so – a lot of people take it personally because golf is like the game of honor and the game of honesty and, you know, the game with all these weird – rules that you have to adhere to constantly.
The sport that the fans call in and go, that was a rules violation.
Right. And, you know, so golf is sacred too, to a lot of people. It's a link between fathers and sons. And it's this amazing opportunity to be out and kind of unbridled in building the relationship and everything that you have to be good at that game is diligence and it's patience and it's all of these virtuous attributes. And so a lot of people, whether you're Rory McIlroy or you're the guy who's over here at Charlotte Country Club on the driving range right now, have taken this super personally.
Yeah.
It's against them.
Yep.
Well, and
more, you're right. More than any other sport, it's even at the highest level, it's the sport that when it's the one sport that when you watch it, you can relate to what's happening because everyone plays or has tried to play. And so there's a relatability to it. When I watch Mike Trout play baseball, I know I can't do that. And I can't do what the PGA Tour's play. But you know what though? But I can attempt to hit it out of the sand, you know, onto the green. You know what I mean? There's a relatability to it. And so because of that, that's why, you know, it's why both our dads loved watching it. And we started watching it because of them, because there's a relatability to it. Yes, you know, you're not going to qualify for the U.S. Open, but you can relate to, oh man, this guy has got to figure out how to hit it from behind this tree. Right. Or this guy's got to figure out how to navigate this lie. We can all relate to that. So there's a relatability and a connection to golf that I don't think exists in any other sport, because there's a part of you that thinks I cannot hit it like Rory McIlroy can. But by God, I've had to hit it off the pine straw. You know, that's part of why people feel like they own the game.
I will sit here and tell you that I believe that I could score an NBA game before I could hit a single shot as well as any of those guys on the PGA Tour.
But again, it's not about the actual performance. It's about the relatability to it. Like, you know what it's like to hold that club in your hand and stand over it. The reality is that most of us don't really play basketball anymore after the age of 21. We don't really, you know, we don't play football anymore. We don't know how to drive an Indy car. You know, we don't know how to do those things. But you know what it's like to line up a putt. And so you appreciate it. So there's a relatability to it. And so, but you also know, because you live out there, anybody who's been to an event, even more so than a motorsports event, which is just one big billboard, golf is more driven by money than anything else. Just the way it looks, the way it feels, everything is ultimately driven through, you know, corporate activation. And so, you know, that's why I get mad when they sit there and they, that's why I got mad at Phil a year ago. It's why I'm mad at Jay Monahan now. Don't sit there and tell me that it's about A, when we all know it's about B. Just say it. You know what? Honestly, we couldn't afford to keep doing it the way we're doing it.
I would still love to know the exact truthful why.
And we will.
So from everything I've read, Jimmy Dunn just like straight up cold texted Yasser and was like, hey man, let's meet.
Yeah.
So they meet in London.
Yeah.
They play some golf.
Yeah.
They smoke some stogies.
Yeah.
And they put this deal together. Yeah. And I just like, what were Jay Monahan, PGA Tour, Bohr, whomever was involved, Jimmy Dunn, whoever, what are they looking at? What are the bullet points that they are looking at going, oh, damn, we better figure out a way to fix this now. And I honestly wonder if it's not, we do not want to go to the court of law and open up these books for the whole world to look at what we're doing.
That's, are you, Marty, suggesting that it's about the money?
Never.
What?
Never do it.
Dollar bills, y'all.
Key, Jay, and Max.
Yeah, let me ask you, Key, would Max be the owner that would be at every game of the team that he owned?
He would be on the field trying to tell the television announcers what they should be seeing.
More from Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max. Weekday mornings at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN2.
How are you? My name is Scott Van Pelt, host of SC Pod. Along with my partner in crime, Stanford Steve. What do we talk about mostly on the podcast, Steve?
Sports.
Some.
Parenting.
I feel like that comes up a lot. I feel like most recently I've needed some help because I feel like my shortcomings there are evident. It's life stuff, you know, relatable content.
It's fun.
It's just two bald-headed goons just talking about nonsense a lot in a crowded podcast space. There's that one.
We're here.
Here we are.
Keyshawn Johnson, Jay Williams, and Max Kellerman.
Jimmy Joe Pesci. Blessings on blessings to everybody on this show, the realest show on ESPN. Why I think Mike is better than LeBron, I'm going to tell you. Numbers don't lie. We're going to do numbers. If you put $100 on LeBron losing all his championships, you will be up $600. If you put $10,000 on Mike winning or his championship, you will be up $60,000. 60 versus 600.
You only put $100 on one, you put $10,000 on the other.
But numbers don't lie, Max. Numbers don't lie. That's it. I understand that, but ain't nobody on the show a mathematician. So numbers don't lie.
GJ and Max, followed by Greeny. Mornings on ESPN Radio and on the ESPN app.
ESPN Daily is presented by YouTube TV.
Steve Brill, I think it's fair to say for a generation of sports fans, and even people who aren't sports fans, the name Gordon Bombay and the Flying V, the Knuckle Puck, these are phrases, these are names that immediately bring to mind great memories from childhood. And a classic film that you wrote, that you created, The Mighty Ducks. Where did the idea come from?
Well, it's funny when you say Gordon Bombay, it's like that, that you say that's iconic, which is funny because I was very young. I was 26 years old and I was drinking gin that summer. And the two gins, if you know, are the most popular back then were Bombay gin and Gordon's gin. And I looked over at the bar and I saw Gordon Bombay and I wrote that as the main character's name.
In the hallowed canon of sports underdog movies, heroes like Rocky and the Bad News Bears often get top billing. But in 1992, a new team came quacking, triple-deking, and flying together to join their ranks, the Mighty Ducks. So ahead of the premiere of the new E60 documentary, Once Upon a Time in Anaheim, we're bringing you a sneak peek. Today, screenwriter Stephen Brill shares what it was like to turn waterfowl into film and how it felt when his creation came to life in the form of an actual NHL team owned by Disney, which ruffled a lot of feathers by naming the team the Mighty Ducks. I'm Jeremy Schapp. It's Friday, June 9th. This is ESPN Daily.
It can be stressful when unexpected expenses come up, but Dave can help. Dave is the banking app that can help you get up to $500 instantly with extra cash. No interest, late fees, or credit check. Join the millions of people who have downloaded Dave and get up to $500 instantly with extra cash. Download the Dave app right now or go to Dave.com. For terms and conditions, go to Dave.com/legal. Instant transfer fees apply. Banking services provided by Evolve. Member FDIC.
This is SportsCenter.
Hello there. I'm Mark Robbins. The Denver Nuggets took game four of the NBA Finals Friday, 108-95 over Miami. Aaron Gordon leading the way with a playoff career high 27 points. The Nuggets win a fifth straight on the road during the playoffs. And after the big win, Gordon spoke about the Denver defense, which he believes helped do the trick.
Contested all of their threes. They were shooting at a high clip when it was uncontested. We knew if we could contest a little bit more, try and just get their field goal percentage down a little bit, three-point percentage down a little bit, I think we'd be in good shape.
That is Aaron Gordon. Denver now with a 3-1 lead in this series, and Game 5 of the NBA Finals is set for Monday in Denver, 7:30 Eastern, for the coverage to begin here on ESPN Radio. Major League Baseball from Friday, the Phillies with a sixth straight victory. Get it in a dramatic moment.
The 1-1. Swung on.
Hit deep. Right field. He's won it. Walk him off, Kyle Schwarber. His fourth career walk-off home run. Kyle Schwarber wins it 5-4 in the bottom of the ninth inning.
They sure do enjoy it on Sports Radio 94 WIP. And meanwhile, Tampa Bay beats Texas 8-3 for the Rays' seventh straight win. On the sour side, the Tigers drop their seventh straight, losing to Arizona, equaled by the Mets, losing 14-7 to the Pirates. Pete Alonso on the IL for at least three or four weeks.
Coming up Monday, I'm going to tell you why it's time for the Lakers to stop playing around and make sure they end up with one of these point guards. Monday morning, 6 a.m. Eastern, ESPN Radio, ESPN2, ESPNU.
Good morning, it's Anna Lynn. If the rooster's crowing, it's time for Marty and McGee.
I've been down the Mississippi.
Becky Danilin, it is time for Hour 2 of Marty McGee on ESPN Radio, the SEC Network, and the ESPN app presented by Progressive Insurance. You can call us 888-SAY-ESPN. It's 888-729-3776. I'm sure Jay Monahan's calling in and talk to me about live golf. Tune in for baseball action today as the Phillies host the Dodgers. Coverage begins at 3:30 p.m. Eastern on ESPN Radio and the ESPN app. Does Cameron know who's joining us at the bottom of the hour?
I forgot to tell him yesterday. I should text him.
ASAP, Tom Mintz.
Although he's 17 years old and it's summer.
He's probably asleep.
So he is probably not awake.
Tom Mintz, monster truck legend, is going to join us. That's the coolest.
Driver of Maximum Destruction.
Yeah.
For those of y'all who are monster truck folks like we are, my little boy, big boy now, he's 6'3". But, man, we had like, I'm not kidding you, I bet we had 10 Max D diecast trucks and would launch them. Man, they were so, that's just so fun. I can't believe we're going to get to talk to Tom. That's gonna be fun.
In my previous life as a feature producer for ESPN 100 years ago, right here in this very studio, we did a show called RPM Tonight, and I did a monster truck story and went up to the Charlotte Motor Speedway and interviewed Tom Mintz, and he was driving, I think, Bigfoot at the time, and he gave his whole technical explanation of how much horsepower there was and how big the tires were, whatever else. And there was this big wing, like on the back of the truck. And he went into this big, long explanation about how that wing was for downforce. And this was back in the day, you know, when spoilers were ruled NASCAR, and every week we'd get a fax. The Fords are getting a quarter inch here and the Pontiacs are losing a half inch there, whatever, on the rear spoiler. But Tom Mintz went into this whole thing about all the downforce that wing created. And we got done. He goes, you know, I made that up, right? There's no downforce on this truck. So I said, yeah. But if you've never been to Monster Jam, it's amazing. David DeLucci going to join us to talk about the NCAA Baseball Super Regionals. Actually going to be here in the Wilderness Lodge Studios. And, of course, Hillbilly Headlines. I got a little worked up about the LIV Golf thing. But you think about that thing dominated our show a year ago. And we talked about it almost every week. And you had just been in the Masters and you were going to the PGA and all these things. And we were talking about it so much last year. I remember the Phil Mickelson's controversial statements about the Saudis, you know, and I'm just doing this to grow golf. That happened. I remember I'd landed in Jacksonville, was driving to Daytona for the Daytona 500 and stopped to have lunch at the World Golf Village there south of Jacksonville. Eating at the deal owned by the Murray brothers, the Caddyshack place. And I'm sitting at the bar eating lunch when the Phil Mickelson thing dropped. And you're talking about a building full of golfers. They're all there to visit the World Golf Hall of Fame and play golf, whatever else. And it fell completely silent. And this one guy in the back goes, "What the hell?" Like right out loud. And that's kind of how it all started. And so but we talked about it a year ago sitting here about in our motorsports world. And we sat right here and said, you know, IndyCar ruled the world, the Indy 500, and they split themselves in half. They killed the goose looking for golden eggs. And eventually it all came back together because they tried it apart and it didn't work. The difference here, and we said that's going to happen here. The difference here is that they headed it off at the pass as opposed to letting it drag on for a decade and a half like IndyCar did. And, but again, do not sell us, try to sell us on the moral, whatever, and the betterment of the game, or whatever else. It's money. It's money, 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 money.
And my boys are convinced right now that that's the most fired up they've ever seen you. In fact, I think they think that's the first time they've ever seen you even a little bit fired up.
Probably. I try to play it cool.
Dang, you want to get McGee?
Don't lie to me.
Kick McGee into overdrive. Just don't talk about LIV Golf.
Bro, but just don't. There's nothing that makes me angrier than. And you and I have dealt with this with athletes. When you ask them a question, and honestly, the athletes don't do it so much as the people who run the sports, like the owners and the whatever else. And when they look us in the eye and try to pull the Jedi mind trick of trying to tell us this is what this is actually about, it insults our intelligence. Like, no, man, damn, I've done a lot of research. I cover the sport. I I'm not an idiot. Just tell me what's going on. Why are you trying to sell me on something that isn't? That's the part that makes me mad. I don't care what it is. Don't act like everyone's just dumb and they're just going to believe whatever you tell them. It's just
from the player side. Okay. Again, if you try to remove yourself from the emotion, whatever your emotion may be.
Yeah.
All right. And you look at it in the context of your own life, which I don't know if that's fair because our lives are not professional athletic lives. So their context may be a little different. But if I'm going to be 100% honest with you. Some of my favorite guys in golf are Brooks Koepka.
Yeah.
Dustin Johnson.
Yeah.
Harold Varner.
Yeah.
Cam Smith is hysterical. I really like Bryson DeChambeau. Yep. I love talking to him and interviewing him. And HV3, Charlatan, go ECU Pirates.
Yeah.
HV3 was like, anybody who tells you that it was for anything except for that paper, they're lying.
And that's why he's the man.
But just, dude, if,
just be look, honest.
If somebody came to any of y'all driving to get the donuts right now, all right, and they said, all right, right now, with all of your sponsorships and with whatever you know, you typically your average earnings are on the PGA Tour or no in your job, and they said, all right, man, look, we are going to offer you the opportunity to go over here, and we're going to offer you the opportunity to make powers and powers and powers, generational money that can take care of your great grandchildren. It's not going to be an easy thing to say no. And so if I'm one of those guys on the tour, like John Rahm or, you know, Rory, although Rory said the other day in a press conference, I found to be interesting that he never got offered anything.
Yeah.
He's the face of the tour, man.
Yeah, I don't know.
But anyway, the point is this. It's easy to sit here and have a lot of angst and frustration that guys took money. But a lot of us would be hard-pressed to not take money.
And be honest about it. Like the reason that – and I was a Phil guy forever. But
Phil Mickelson got 200 million.
Right.
200 million.
Well, then just say
right. No, I look,
they
I,
gave I just, me $200 million. Dollars. Saying that I'm doing this for the betterment of golf, that's just – Don't lie to me.
Right. That's why HV is the man. HV said,
just be honest.
They paying me 40, 50 million bucks. By God.
Yep.
Hey.
Terry Labonte. At the Daytona 500 one year, Terry Labonte had retired. He was done. He had gone back to Texas to his ranch. And at the Daytona 500 one year, back in the days of the past champions provisionals, for people who don't know, back in the day, if you had won a championship, and you didn't qualify on speed, and you would get the last shotgun in the field. You get the 43rd starting spot because you're a past champion. You're a legend. You get to be in the race. You earn that right. I was at the Daytona 500 and walked. I love walking all the way down in the turn four.
Down there where the Pirates are at?
Right. Down there. I love on race morning, you walk all the way to the end of the grid because the view down there is amazing. Looking down in the turn four and the stands are packed or whatever. And I go down there, Terry Labonte starting shotgun in the field, 43rd. Had retired, came out of retirement, and this, you know, janky race team had said, Terry, would you come drive for us so we can make the Daytona 500? Great. And he's leaning up against the car, and I walked up, and I go, what the hell are you doing right now? He goes, what? I go, you said you don't want to do this anymore, you don't want to get hurt, whatever else. And he looked at me, he goes, do you understand how much money they're paying me to be here today? Great.
I don't even know.
Just be honest. But he didn't say to me, yeah, you know what? I'm here because I think it's important for the sport that, you know, that the two-time Winston Cup champion be here today. I'm here today because, you know, I think it's important for the great America. No, they paid him like $250,000. Just show up.
I'm not trying to be a jerk or anything like that. But he told you that to your face.
Yeah.
If you had a camera in his face, that ain't what he'd have said.
Maybe, but,
and I'm not saying it's right or wrong. I'm just telling you that life is context and repetition.
Yeah.
And yes, they took the money.
And
Brooks Koepka got nine figures. Dustin Johnson got nine figures.
Unapologetic. And I would have done it. I would have done it in a heartbeat.
And Will Zalatoris turned down $130 million reportedly. Yeah. I would have to believe that even if they never came to Rory and said, we're going to offer you this, they went to somebody in Rory's camp.
Yeah.
And said, we got however many hundred millions of dollars, on and on, right?
Yeah.
And so those guys in the public eye are going to say, well, we're growing golf. All of us go,
yeah.
But they got paid a lot of money. Right. And now what's fascinating now is, okay, now we've shifted to the point where golf's going to kind of unify again, we think.
Yeah.
And, all right, so what does that mean for Brooks Koepka, who finished second in the Masters and he eats his lunch that he didn't win the Masters because he took his foot off the gas. He took his foot off the gas and John Rahm won the Masters. All right. So there's been two major championships in 2023. Brooks Koepka easily could have won them both.
Yep.
Finished second at Augusta National, won the PGA Championship in a dominant performance.
Yep.
All right. What does it mean for those guys now coming back into this unified, whatever they call
it? Not going to be unified, but that's cool.
whatever they call it.
Yeah.
There's so many layers to this. And I said this yesterday on our boy Taylor Zarzer's show, who knows more about golf and knows more people in golf, is more connected in golf than anybody on earth. The players, like when we were at Augusta National for the first few days at Augusta, all of us at the Masters, all of us were on TV talking about, oh man, it might be contentious. It might be. Players are like, man, whatever. Yeah. We live together in Jupiter, Florida, and we play practice rounds every other day together. And we are here not for that narrative. We are here to win this tournament.
Yeah.
And so I do wonder, like, okay, how are those, what are Monahan and those guys going to do, Jimmy Dunn and whoever's making decisions? What are the parameters going to be and the stipulations going to be for them to come back? Fascinating to me, too, that Rory and other PGA Tour players who decided to stay say we should be compensated for staying.
Yeah, well, and that's what Mark Sleball and others wrote about yesterday, which is this idea of like an equity sharing thing. But you know what I go back to all the time? One of my favorite movies is Office Space. And it's and there's that scene where the guys come in, the consultants come in, and they sit down with the guy. And they're interviewing everybody, and they're trying to decide who they're going to lay off and who they aren't. They look at Peter, and they go, you know, would you be more motivated to work more? Because he's just basically said, I just come to work every day and I don't actually do anything. So would you be more motivated if we offered you like an equity sharing plan, you know, like a stock option? He goes, I don't know, guys. And that's kind of what I keep going back to about it. But anyhow, the idea is we're going to unify golf. The reality is that yes, they will be unified and yes, they'll all be back in the clubhouse together and they'll be traveling together, whatever else. They're never going to trust the commissioner again. Never. None of them. And he's going to make them money and all that's fine. But at the end of the day, they will never fully believe anything he says going forward.
As we sit here right now on June, whatever today is, at 8:15 in the morning.
Yeah.
If this thing transpires the way it's written, Jay Monahan now has more power.
Yeah.
Because he now oversees LIV Golf too.
Yeah.
Dude.
I know. And good for him. But don't tell me that it's kumbaya and here we go and let's all hold hands and you know go down to the 19th hole and act like everything's great. It's just fine. Just if you are going home like Scrooge McDuck and sitting on a big pile of money and laughing to the bank, fine, own it. It's Marty McGee on ESPN Radio, the SEC Network, and the
Follow
ESPN app.
Follow the money.
King, Jay, and Max.
Jay, why are you all of a sudden dressed like you're going to go do a magic show?
They say Jay Copperfield for sure.
More from Keyshawn, Jable, and Max. Weekday mornings at 6 Eastern on ESPN Radio and on ESPN2.
MLB fans, when you need tickets to catch your favorite team live all season long, Ticketmaster's got them. As the world's largest ticket marketplace, Ticketmaster has a wide selection of seats available and at competitive prices, so you never have to worry about missing a game. Take yourself out to the ballpark this season and get tickets today at Ticketmaster.com/MLB. That's Ticketmaster.com/MLB.
Will they find a home? Sponsored by Geico. Sarah wants a yard.
My own little paradise.
Brad, however, hates yard work.
The only thing I hate more than cutting the grass is paying someone to cut the grass.
Compromise is tough, but these two won't have to compromise when they bundle home and car insurance with Geico. It's easy, and they could save even more. In the end, Sarah and Brad found a great home with a yard. A very, very small yard.
Time to get it done. And I'm done.
Bundling without compromise at geico.com.